Who rode the bike? Who rode the bike?
Me.
Oh, you ride that bitch?
Yeah.
I be riding my bike.
I brought you a bag out.
Man, you don't be riding.
I don't be doing all that.
I cruise.
I hit the back roads and like to ride through all the little scenic routes.
But you fought them. You got that one. You got that one.
Mm-hmm. Ooh. You're getting old, boy.
I got 10
What's
shows
happening?
Now.
What's happening?
Oh, my bad. Boy, Birmingham done sold that motherfucker out. Well, I got 10 of them bitches.
Yeah,
that's what I said. They trying to add a win. I said, I ain't finna do myself like that.
You better than me. I ain't doing over 6. I haven't told them. They be trying you too.
Hey, I ain't even gonna lie though.
Only I be reason, horsed by the 6-1.
I be horsed by the 3rd. Gang.
Sure. Y'all
be safe. Keep going. Stay down. Stay thank prayed up. So Lil Mama.
Appreciate the love.
Be safe. Thank you so much. Y'all stay down, man. We gon' boy, that shit was that shit was hitting.
I thought everybody got their shit.
That shit was just booming, boy.
Okay.
I ain't gonna lie to you. But you know what I really don't like doing, bro? Like you said, I don't mind doing 6-2-2-2. Cause by that second one.
I can't do 3 shows. That shit.
Listen.
It feel like a job after that.
Bro, it feel like a job after the first. Cause I tell myself I'm not gonna go full throttle the first. The first show, you done went dumb, bonkers, stupid. And by the time you think about it, you like, man, I can't do this shit.
And them sound systems don't be that good, so you straining more.
Mm-mm. Come on, man. The only reason why I went crazy, Kanil, man, you see my man.
Get that money up.
I gotta get my money back. Come on, fucker, don't look at you.
You
like,
back
you
working
ain't
too?
No lick.
You ain't fucking with it?
You ain't fucking with it?
I mean, the show I had booked,
you know,
that was
the Gonzalez
started.
Shit.
I'll be in y'all city this month. Yeah. I mean, Mississippi.
You started though.
Yeah, but I'm only doing like 1 a month.
Why?
Just that I was cool with not working no more this year, but I just wanted to
continue to get
to
it
keep my
after,
to
yeah,
keep my
feet
shit
wet.
Yeah, keep right. My shit straight.
And that rest of shit do happen.
Nah, this shit like exercise when you stop for a while, you feel it.
Right, right, right.
So I just do it to make sure. But usually, damn, by the second show, I be like, man, I ain't really got to do this, mo.
Right. why you don't want to get back out there? I just feel
like it's still a bunch of sick motherfuckers out there to me.
Yeah.
That's just me, though.
Ain't going nowhere, though.
But this the only reason why I said
it. Man, you don't. Honestly, the most protected person is the nigga on the stage. I'm not doing meet and greet.
No, I'm not doing no meet and greet. But this my thing. This my thing. This my only reason. This my only reason why I say go get your money. Unless you just literally at the crib all day, every day. You still out here with the people. You still. We can go to the grocery store. When you going to be about to talk to the weed man. Nigga right here. You know what I'm saying? Period. You feel me? So it's like even just basic shit, basic need of just how you living, I'm still gonna be around 150 of you motherfuckers. Go to Walmart right now.
Boy,
that shit bigger than the comedy club.
I ain't been to Walmart in about a year.
For real?
I swear I ain't.
Where you been buying your shit?
I just ordered it, have it sent to the crib.
Even that? How the fuck you know the mailman ain't got this shit?
I don't.
Right.
Leave it on the porch. Leave it on the doorstep and get the hell out of here.
You on the doorstep for 14 days.
Now, if I had like other sources of income, well, it would cool. Like at the end of the day, I couldn't have worked no more this year and still have paid my bills. You see what I'm saying? Like I couldn't have still went to work and still would have been straight. But it's just to the principle.
Like, underneath is like notes and stories and shit.
I don't like spending.
That's what they for. I'm just here to answer. What the fuck? You doing me like that? I ain't come to work, man.
But nah, nigga. I'ma go get that bag.
I don't blame you.
Fuck that.
I don't blame you.
I got too many motherfuckers to feed.
I don't blame you. The only thing
I
is,
don't
is
blame
like,
you.
I ain't had no,
right.
No.
That's what I said. I don't blame you that not going either.
Nah.
Fuck that.
That's what I'm saying.
I can't sit on my ass, bro. I'm too much of a hustler, bro. I ain't like that. That shit that shit just ain't in me. I mean, if I was 50, I don't give a fuck. I would've been like, man, fuck that. I'm sorry.
Now when you see how fun it is just chilling.
Man, what you mean I want to chill so bad? I want to go on the road.
You just said, man, I just can't sit still.
No, what I'm saying is I don't mind that. You feel what I'm saying? I don't mind just going and kicking and doing. I done did that already. But what I'm saying is I got to go get some money, man. That's what I do. That's what I do. If a nigga be like, hey, well, one thing you know about Shawty is Shawty stay to himself and Shawty know how to get some money. That's what I do. So I can chill and do that anytime. That's nothing. But what I do.
You at the age where you're supposed to be getting this money. You're supposed to be getting everything you can.
That's what I do.
At my age, I...
But you know what I'm saying? But you're not racked up. You've been in the game. You've been having your business.
I could be, don't get to it. I still want some more money, but I ain't.
You know what I'm saying? But you know what I'm saying?
I think smaller than I do think harder.
No, but you know what I'm saying? It just started on my end. You see what I'm saying?
That's why I ain't knocking you. Nigga.
Right, you see what I'm saying?
That's all you can. I tell niggas, don't follow me. Do me when you my age.
No, but do what I'm also saying. But do what I'm also saying, too. It wouldn't have hurted me if I didn't go work again the rest of this year. Because I think strategically and methodically ahead like that. Like, rainy day. Nigga, it's been a rainy day since March 15th to my first show in August, nigga. But that was thunderstorm every motherfucking day. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it like, nigga be like, can you hold off and be like, shit. Now, what's up with the rainy day? Can you really manage? I know how to manage, but I'm tight.
Yeah.
Nigga, I eat $20 a week.
Hey, you just feel so.
No, I didn't. Oh, Lord. I can't keep nothing clean. I can't keep nothing clean. I'm 28, I can't keep nothing clean. Mm-hmm. I can't keep nothing clean. I'm 28 and I look at this shit. These just come out the cleaner. Nigga, look at this shit. Mm-hmm. They just came out the cleaner. You still see the crease, my nigga?
No, I don't.
It's in the jeans, my nigga.
No, it ain't.
It's in the crease, my nigga.
Where about?
By my knees, my nigga. Oh, I can't keep nothing clean. Mm-hmm. Can a nigga bring me a napkin, please? Can't keep nothing clean.
Y'all ain't gonna get him a napkin up for real?
No, it's real shit, though.
Hey, man, welcome back to the 85 South Show. We in here today, and we are up to the usual shenanigans, but it is not your typical day in the Trap House, D.C. We got a very special guest.
Who in the trap? Who
man,
in the trap?
We got a motherfucking living legend in the trap with us today, man. We got none other. This motherfucking Lil Duval.
Where he at?
Right here.
Where he at?
No, they ain't right there.
Oh, there you go. What's up, nigga?
What's going on, nigga?
My
boy.
We've
been getting a lot of requests to have you come through the trap, man.
Yeah, man, I know it, man. They've been hitting me up. Like, when you going to go over there to 85 South? But I guess because I fuck with y'all so hard, you know, we take it for granted. Be like, man, this be there. You be like, he'll come through. So now we finally here, so.
We here, we locked in. Got the OG.
Right. Yeah. Just like you said, you always knew that you would come, and it's like shit, we'll get it.
Yeah, that's we just be like, it'll come. You know, it's gonna. I like stuff to happen organically, and that's how this happened, organically. But damn near forgot I was supposed to come till you called me this morning. Like,
goddamn.
You still fucking with it?
Man, come on, man.
Oh, yeah.
But see, that's the thing. We gotta go ahead and put shit, you know what I'm saying, in fruition. Sometimes we can't wait.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you gotta make that phone call.
Yeah, this is the perfect time too. There's so much shit going on in the world. And you've been navigating this shit like a whole G.
Yeah, cause I've been sticking to myself.
Exactly.
It's been stuff going on in the world, but not in my world.
Shawty, you a traveling motherfucker, man.
I'm a living motherfucker. It ain't so much the traveling, I just live, you know? And in the midst of me living, I do a little traveling here, because some of the stuff I like to do, it ain't here. Cause if it was here, I wouldn't go nowhere.
Right, like swimming with sharks.
Yeah, I fuck with the swimming with the sharks. I just like swimming, you know? And I learned through swimming by bumping into a couple sharks that they ain't what we think they is.
Yeah, they some whole nother other shit.
They ain't thinking about us.
I ain't going down there, though.
Come on, man, go with me.
No, because I went deep sea. I ain't really go deep sea dive. I went to snorkeling shit.
Oh,
the scuba. Oh,
man.
With the tube, but they keep the neck on the helmet, but you can go back 20 feet.
Oh, that bullshit.
Hell no, but you can go back 20 feet, though. Nigga, you crazy.
You that shit ain't
gonna
go.
You turn around and see one of them motherfuckers.
That shit don't go no
down.
Goddamn 20 feet, man.
Yeah, your ass
was on
some adventures too. I remember you got trapped in that cave or some shit.
Oh yeah, I almost died. I done almost died a couple times.
Yeah, on social media too.
Right.
Yeah, I had got stuck in I went down this little cave in Jamaica where you go through this way and come out the other way. But while I went down there, I had missed and went that way. And I didn't know where to go after that, so I had to hurry up and get out, and I didn't know where to go, and I kept bumping my head, and
ooh.
Almost died. But luckily, I went back the other way and came back out where I came
in. I would have panicked. I was shitting on myself again.
That's the key. That's what people don't realize. Panicking is real. Like,
right.
You got to really know how to calm your ass down, and I learned through scuba diving how to keep my composure, even in everything in life. I learned a lot through scuba diving.
Yeah, so like, you do a lot of adventurous shit that the average nigga don't do. What do you just get bored a lot? And like, where you find the motivation and inspiration to do shit like scuba diving and flying a plane?
I think it comes from just simply from living and doing so much. I've always wanted to do, like, I get tired of stuff easy, so I say, all right, what I'm gonna do next? I'm gonna do this next. And then I say, all right, I'm gonna do this. And then if I see everybody else doing something, I wanna do something else.
Right.
So by the midst of me being old now, I done a lot of shit. So it's just now I'm on the next level. Cause like now I'm trying to fly, but every nigga my age be about to fly now. I'm just, to y'all it seemed new, but to people my age, this is what they normally do.
Right, you want to be a Tuskegee Airman?
No, I ain't want to. It's just I'm at that level now. It's like, all right, I done did this, I done did that. What I ain't did? I ain't never flew before. Let me try to fly.
What's next?
I don't know. Whatever I feel like doing. I didn't think I was going to be goddamn off-roading like a motherfucker until I started this year.
Real.
I love that shit.
That off-road shit off chain.
Yeah, I like mud and I like just, he a country boy. He know how that shit
hell
be. That
yeah.
Shit fun as hell.
Yeah,
like
at the
that.
House doing that shit.
Hell yeah.
That nigga going crazy with his shit.
You be on four-wheelers though, ain't
yeah, you
but have you ever skydived?
Yeah, I done that.
Nah, that's stupid actually. White people shit.
No,
you
ain't.
Got one of the coldest.
Ain't, we
mottos.
Gotta stop saying shit. White people shit. That's living, man.
No, that's white people shit. That ain't living.
White people shit. That's
I
living.
Watch your stupid ass.
It ain't just white people doing it though.
I
it
know.
Ain't. We all doing. We
it
just
was stupid black people who was influenced by stupid white people.
Nah, we just getting there. Like we thought everything was stupid, and then next thing you know, we doing it. Cause we
I would have did it though. I got asthma, so that's why I can't do it.
With the scuba diving shit?
Nah, with the skydiving. That's too much air for me to take in and breathe at one time. Mm-hmm. Shit real.
I don't know about that.
I know
be out
I'm
there
the
trying
old
to
nigga.
Grab
I'm the
some
old
breath
nigga with
and
his
shit.
Feet crossed. Yeah. I'm the only nigga with his feet crossed. That's how you know I'm the old nigga in this bitch.
Nigga can't even breathe.
But like I said, you got one of the coldest mottos of this whole pandemic, nigga. We in this together, but stay the fuck away from me.
Right.
That's real. That was me before that
don't
shit.
Don't pull up on me.
I'm with y'all, but don't get too close to me. I'm nervous. I'm a young little nigga. I get nervous. So that's why I say stay the fuck away from me.
So you ain't been going back to work?
Oh yeah, I've been performing. I've been doing shit here and there. I try to keep my whistle wet, you
right,
know.
Right, right, right.
Stay on stage because this shit like the gym. If you miss it too long, you feel it.
Yes,
you know? So I try to stay on stage until everything open wide back up. Plus, I use this time to work on new shit. Try to slip new shit in here and there.
Right.
What's one of your favorite cities to work on your new shit? Because you know, it's certain cities. That
it's not so much the city; it's the crowd.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
You know, certain crowds, especially when you're doing these comic clubs, you do. You do a bunch of shows in 1 week.
Right.
So some crowds, you know, all right, I gotta perform. And some of them, they just go with you. You be like, oh, I can try something here.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
So
I think Nashville like that. I love Nashville.
Nashville show love.
Baltimore lit too. You can try
Baltimore
shit in Baltimore.
Show love.
Nashville will watch me for about 20 minutes. They'll let me do comedy.
Yeah.
For 20 minutes. Then they like, nah, fuck that, bro. Say that shit.
Yeah,
we
yeah,
fuck
yeah,
with
yeah.
Your dope, bro, but say that shit,
right,
bro.
Right,
we
yeah.
Don't want that part.
Right.
Now
right.
Just say that shit.
Yeah.
Talk about this nigga over here, bro.
Yeah,
we
yeah.
Bought this nigga just so you could talk about him.
Mm-hmm.
It be them crowds like that. See, that's the shit I
mean. Miami here. They sit front row. They like they here. Nigga, I know you see these goddamn
Miami
shoes.
Some weird ass
they be like,
crowds,
these niggas
too.
Crazy, yeah. Man.
Bro, they showed us much love when we went to Jacksonville.
Miami always
too.
Showed me love from day one.
Yeah.
Now, Miami lit. I just
since
got booked
Coconut
in Miami.
Grove Improv. You did Coconut back
yeah.
In the day.
Hell yeah. After Benji do 2 hours.
On the first show.
And then you got to do an hour. Then he going to do another one.
They always showed me love. I ain't never had no problem, even with them doing a lot of time before me.
I never had no
issue. Motherfuckers do y'all like that?
Nah, cause it was
most comedians.
It was a nice club, but it was a hood room, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay,
nice ass club, but it was a hood ass room.
Like, motherfuckers do what they want to do.
I'm talking about this where all the good drug dealers was at. Like, these were niggas who was waiting on an ounce. These was successful drug dealers.
Kilo motherfuckers.
Successful strippers. And beautiful whores and things of that nature. And then you'll see some weird shit. It'd be a white dude who looked like he the manager at the movie theater, leave with 9 bad bitches and jump in a Bentley.
Damn.
Shit like that. It was just a strange, balling ass club.
It was normal to me because I'm from Florida. So to me, I didn't notice the weird stuff, cause it, I guess, cause
in
I'm
Florida, y'all got some like white niggas. Like,
see,
them white
Florida
folks
got some rich
like
niggas
real.
That you don't even know. Ooh. It be some rich niggas that play like baseball for the Marlins or something, show up
for real?
And they have like 5 motherfucking Rolls Royces outside, 22 hoes, and you like, why these hoes ain't talking to nobody? These is all his hoes.
Damn. Mm-hmm.
It be one club full of one nigga hoes. Only in Miami,
man. I remember Santana Moss now, Santana, Clinton Porters, and somebody else, they had a party in L.A. I mean, not in L.A., in D.C. And, you know, when the football players, they say, man, we're going to have hoes and everything.
Right.
So I'm thinking, shit, we all finna be fucking. Come and find out all these hoes were they hoes.
They was they hoes. That is the worst
hoes,
shit.
And you couldn't do shit because they fucking all them hoes. So they we was just there. That shit was not fun.
That's a terrible
why?
Feel. Like,
why
when you walking through
none?
A room full of somebody else
hoes. Focused on these niggas.
Just these, on the football players. Just.
Yes, they was going for the bag. They was going for the bag. Oh, and yeah. These when these niggas were hot.
Right. And then it'd be one of them niggas that'd be worth $100 million.
Yeah, you can't compete with no $100 million nigga, man.
You gotta have that sauce. That way you just gotta whip it out. Wham! Yeah.
Not on these hoes.
Come here, baby.
Not on these hoes. I don't give a
come
fuck.
Come here, baby.
I don't give a fuck.
Bitch, you on cocaine.
Sauce.
Shut up. Shit, yes. This motherfucker huge. You high as hell. Come on with it.
Only way you gonna get some pussy is you hang out all weekend and you catch them before they about to leave. She might.
Oh, you catching that hoe sleepwalking.
You catch that hoe that the nigga done ran off, the nigga tired of, that she ain't getting fucked. So you be like, all right, I'll fuck you. You gotta catch that hoe.
Damn,
the one you, the one that's gonna fuck you, everybody come like, bro, you fuck what?
Yeah, you fucked up. That's who you want, man.
Damn, it was hard back then.
Man.
Shit, it's like that now. You fuck with the right batch of hoes.
All these hoes ran through.
All of them.
All of them.
And they got, they had, the worst thing,
I know she ran through.
The worst thing about these hoes is it don't matter what you doing, they have been somewhere and had more fun.
Listen to me. You turning up, listen, she done turned up way 10 times harder than this.
That's why I don't fuck.
He think he doing something.
That's why I don't fuck with them Instagram hoes. I fuck with the Facebook aunties.
Man.
Because they take care of you.
Church!
You got to take care of them hoes on Instagram.
Getting the women from church.
Them Instagram hoes.
I'm going to put that on Twitter right now. Hold on, where am I
them Instagram hoes.
I'm tweeting that.
Will tell you.
That's
a hard tweet, ain't it?
What?
I said, what I said, shit.
Nigga all the time. That nigga crazy.
You got to take care of them Instagram hoes.
Yeah, Instagram hoes, you got to take care of them. Facebook hoes, they take care of you.
For real.
Stay woke.
Facebook hoes be old as hell. How you doing? Darling. Bitch, don't call me no darling.
Bitch, I love darling.
The fuck is a darling?
I'll take it.
What's a darling? I'll bitch, I ain't no darling. Baby doll, bitch. They don't call me no darling. I'm a grown ass man, bitch. Fuck wrong with you? How you doing, darling? Bitch,
shit.
Darling. Bitch, go read. It's other words.
And bitches, they call you darling, cook for you after you fuck.
Mm-hmm.
God damn it.
Darling, she like using candles. I hope she got insurance.
Shit.
One time I was with this. I was with this famous Instagram girl.
Zero.
Hey, one time I was with this famous Instagram girl though, and it's like, her phone kept ringing, and the niggas who was calling, I was like, you need to go talk to these motherfuckers. You over here bullshitting with me. These are the life changers.
This the one that can put you where you need to be.
Yeah, these.
Man, let me tell you something. All of them ran through, man. Unless you got somebody with no followers who don't even be on social media, because social media is a whole nother world.
This is one thing that men gonna have to just come to terms with.
Your bitch been ran through before.
No, it's
you did.
That too. But women like dick more than we think they do.
Yes, they do.
Oh, they enjoy it. They are more.
They got favorites.
Than we are.
Yes.
Come on. Yeah. How you think we is about women? The exact way about.
I realize when you become somebody, the tables turn, so you see everything that you think that a woman ain't, because they be it with you. You know what I'm saying? Like, they might.
This
you,
deep.
Nah, for real.
It's too deep.
You going somewhere. Keep going, OG.
Hold up. Slow it down. Slow it down.
For real, because they be, like, we think, you know how we put girls in category, be like, nah, she ain't no hoe. She ain't no freak.
Right.
But when you somebody and they creeping.
Right. You see it.
You see all the bullshit. So you don't, you treat all the women like hoes off top and let them tell you where to put you, where the category to put you in. Mm-hmm. Put them in. You feel what I'm saying?
I see what you're saying. So you saying once you meet a girl off top, she a hoe.
No, you treat them all, because every woman want to be a hoe. They just don't want to be known as one. They don't want to be out
there. That's another tweet. Tweet that one.
That's a good tweet?
That's the tweet. That's the tweet right now.
Did you just come up here to fuck up shit and leave?
No, that was the tweet. I'm the OG, right?
That was the tweet. Okay, they always want to be hoes. They just don't know who to be a hoe with.
No, they don't want to know who to be a hoe with.
They don't want to be known for hoes.
They don't want everybody to know they a hoe.
Because I think this is my theory.
Like, I appreciate discreet hoes.
Maybe.
See, I need to be more discreet, too.
Maybe it's just a certain group of individuals that these women will be hoes for.
Exactly.
And to be included in that group is a privilege. Some dudes ain't never gonna get the experience like what true hoes do.
Yeah, they not, because they just talk too fucking much.
They just gonna get the surface.
They talk too much. You don't do that.
And they need niggas like us to tell them the adventures that we been on with these hoes, so they can be aware of the other side.
And I know you know, because ain't you the proclaimed like side nigga? What you is?
But see, my life has been taken into a whole nother direction.
Oh, no, you got an old lady.
No, never mind. The information that I gathered as a side nigga. Will forever be cherished and used in my advantage.
That's what I'm saying. You learned a lot.
Right.
Like, I learned
to be a fly on the wall.
Let me tell you how to cheat. When you cheat with somebody that's with somebody too.
Right.
So if you get caught, she get caught too. Stay woke. You see what I'm saying?
But that can also be dangerous too, because that nigga can be a killer.
No, because she got to have a lot
to lose. He'll pull up on your ass, so you better be ready to.
No, if she got a lot to lose, she's not going to be out here wilding.
Right. She's watching her.
She's not going to be out. Not that I cheat, because black men don't cheat.
Never have and never will.
Never will, but I'm just saying, if you do go down
there. I'm talking to the white men that do.
Yeah, and if you do cheat, cheat with a bitch in the military, because them bitches are professional cheaters.
Right.
And they'll really shoot you. Don't
now
need
this,
it.
Now, this the whole thing, though.
Very good at cheating.
No, they real loyal.
Now, look here. If you're not.
To their side, nigga.
But look, if you're not with your main lady or your side bitch, you cheating.
You're not wrong when you're right. You're not wrong when you're right.
That's just the facts.
Honestly.
Say that one more time.
If you're not with your main lady or your side chick, you are out here bad. You cheating. Right. That's cheating.
Let me tell you something about cheating for
you're
real.
Definitely cheating.
I've never cheated with my dicks off.
Huh?
I've never cheated when my dick was soft.
That means he wasn't trying to fall in love with the
Which
bitch.
Which means...
Come on, no, somebody!
No, that means...
Damn, he was getting enough pussy, he didn't
Keep
no
my
more.
Dick soft, and I never cheat. You see what I'm saying, ladies? If you don't want your man to not cheat, keep your dick soft. Keep his dick soft.
The hell are you talking about?
Keep his dick soft. That means every time his dick get hard, keep it soft. Because if his dick soft, he not around here fucking.
He can eat some coochie.
You see what I'm saying? Do you see what I'm going with this? I'm trying to teach the women how to keep your man from cheating.
Basically, what keep he's his saying off. Is an empty ball sack prevents a broken heart.
Stay woke.
So what you saying is, give him some coochie before he leave the house.
Every time his dick is hard, get it soft.
That's the truth.
That's how you...
Don't get mine soft. Don't listen to him. Get mine hard, lady.
A nigga ain't never cheated with his dick
soft. I need mine rock like a rock.
It's impossible.
Like a rock.
It's impossible to cheat with his dick
soft. I'm trying to go crazy. Do not listen to him, ladies.
I feel like this part... This part of the game...
Y'all don't understand the logic.
I want a Samoan rock. Oh, yeah. I'm a little... You did. I don't know what he's talking about.
I found the cheat code to that.
What's that?
You got to find a lady that'll give you some pussy even when she mad.
Who?
Huh?
You got to find a lady that'll give you some pussy even when she mad.
Even when she mad.
You see how quiet the room got?
Yep.
You can hear the lights.
I don't want no pussy.
They moan, man.
Wait. I don't know, because that could go wrong, because if she give you some pussy, because we in a vulnerable state when we about to nut, she could beat the shit out of you. Ain't nothing you can do about it.
That's an ass whooping.
I'm willing to take. When you get, he like, I don't want to bust a nut. She like that.
She ride. You like that? A bitch fuck nigga. Don't you ever?
Because you can't fight back.
You can't fight back.
You crazy as hell.
Can't fight back. No, not while you nuttin'. This
you must ain't never almost drowned before.
No, yes, I have. Right. Many times. That's what, and it wasn't nothing I could do but try to survive.
And you got out that water, did you?
Barely.
All right, then.
Barely with God. Shit, and that's what's gonna get you out of there when you nuttin'. Heck, is there anything you was able to do while y'all was nuttin'?
Nothing.
Nothing. Ain't nothing you could do while you nuttin'.
Grab that scrap.
Hey, that's crazy. Ain't nothing you could do while
you nuttin'. I heard keys.
You ain't grabbing nothing while you nuttin'.
He younger than us, man.
He younger. He's not grabbing no. I'm willing to bet that. I want to get a bitch to make him nut.
I'ma look right in the camera.
The pistol.
I'm gonna be look right in the camera.
Grab the pistol while nuttin'. Let's see if you can do it.
I grab it.
I'm gonna look right in the camera and tell you, I am at the age where I fall asleep before she back with the towel. I surrender.
Shit,
before
I'm
she even, you want a towel?
Hey, baby.
I'm asleep. She got to wake me all the way up for the towel. I'm talking about I'm asleep. Like, what towel? Girl, that was hours ago. I fucked you tonight.
Me too, baby.
He told my girl that was hours ago. And
I get a towel. I'm a homeowner. If I get a lay here,
shit, I'm at the age where I will fall asleep on some pussy.
Come on,
that nigga,
man.
I will Netflix and chill.
What?
Or fuck the sleep,
man.
That nigga, that's stupid.
Sometimes I don't even have to get the pussy. I just like falling asleep with pussy close by.
Yeah, that's it. You just want to know the fact that you know you can get the pussy. You're like,
right.
Oh, fuck.
Right.
Yeah, if she
right.
on right. that end of the couch with her panties off and I'm over here asleep, I won. Right. I get some pussy in
even
the
even in the conversation mm-hmm. where you tell your homeboy, she was naked in the bed and everything.
Yeah.
That's gangster shit.
That's the best part.
That's that shit.
Highlight of the old nigga story. She came in, got butt naked, jumped right in the bed. This the part we be overlooking when a nigga say, with me. Why was you already in the bed?
Yeah, nigga. It's a win. Shit, I could have fucked. I ain't wanna fuck. Shit. Piss
her
off.
She with me now. I still ain't here. It's Sunday.
She just waiting.
I'ma go knock off tonight. I'ma go knock.
Do her a favor. At this age, you doing these hoes a favor.
Talk your shit.
Oh my God. That's why I can't mess with
I'm a boost.
None of the city girls. All they gotta do is give me one round of coochie. I'm falling asleep. They can rob me blind. I'm gonna wake up where I fell asleep at.
Yeah.
Everything in the house gone.
Can't do that.
That's why you stick with old women. But you gotta
somebody
be
listen.
Straight. Well, you gotta be straight up with old women. Don't talk more than you can bite off.
Talk your shit.
For real with them old women, because they don't expect you to do all that.
Them old women be wanting you there all day though.
Not really. They just want to have a good time. They ain't with the
they
bullshit.
Good time want to know you all day.
Tell
bitch,
the truth,
all
though,
day?
Them young
it's
women
a field
weird.
Trip.
They too weird. They do strange shit that you don't even know strange until you get by yourself and you think about it. Like, you bring a young chick to the crib, man.
These yeah. young hoes smell like pee.
You lose it. You been a lost in the house and then you find
straight
her upstairs
up.
In a weird ass bedroom.
It ain't just me, huh?
Right, they do. They ain't wiping good.
They ain't wiping good. These hoes wiping this way. They
not wiping, you know what they doing?
They wiping like
they padding.
They padding.
Why your hoes smell like pee, bro?
I say these young hoes smell like pee.
You gotta make them hoes take a bath, OG.
No, these young hoes be out, man. These young hoes be out too much.
I bet
like,
you.
When do they have time to they out partying, they own perks? Like, they just, it's just too much going on.
You lick
if
a young
a bitch
chick
on
neck,
the perk,
you
now
know
that
it's going to be salty.
A lot of crack.
These bitches doing perks. It's at an amazing number now with these young hoes with the drugs.
It like perk 30. That one crack too.
Yeah.
Powder.
Lick a neck. I bet a neck salty.
That shit stank.
I'm telling
old,
you,
old sour titty.
Mm. That come from taking baths in the goddamn sink.
I'm sink bath.
I'm sink bath.
How many times they got dipped the rag in the sink?
They don't really do. They use that Bath and Body Works to spray it off to offset it.
That's if it's some around. They don't even be having their own soap. They will wash up with some hand soap.
If you say I'm lying, ladies, prove me wrong. Let me smell it.
They gonna all say we messing with the wrong kind of women.
I know they is, but prove me wrong.
But that ain't their business.
Not that I fuck any of you women, because I don't cheat.
I don't blame you.
Some of them be using that, what it is, that original soap. That shit don't work. Y'all, they still be musty.
Mm-hmm.
That organic soap.
Who needs to use that Mitchum? It worked 48 hours. The men version.
That's not what I'm not finna do. I'm not about to argue with a chick that be musty sometimes.
That shit is a pet peeve of mine. You smell that. I ain't really got time, man. Let me go ahead and be clear, man. Check this out. If you looking for a good place, man, to have fresh food, deliver on time, and give back to the community, nigga, HelloFresh offers so many recipes to choose from each week to help you break out of your recipe route, including low-calorie, vegetarian, and family-friendly recipes every week. You know, because I got a second baby, you dig? So I got to have somebody who gonna bring the food fresh. I'm talking about on time, and it's already prepped up. So when I cut it out and put it on the stove, it take me about 15 minutes. Hey, man, anybody out there like saving money? You like discounts? Well, guess what? You can save up to 28% by using HelloFresh versus your grocery store shopping trip. HelloFresh offers fresh, high-quality ingredients every week for a super flavorful experience. So what I'm trying to tell you is, make sure you go to HelloFresh.com/85South80. And you know what? I told you to give back. On your first meal at HelloFresh.com, you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna take off $80. Yes, sir. So make sure you go to HelloFresh.com/85South80 to get that discount. Don't worry about it. Don't trip. Because HelloFresh be cutting out all the stressful meals, planning and grocery store trips, so you can enjoy cooking and get to the dinner, all right? So go on and get your cook on. Make sure you go to HelloFresh.com/85South80 to get $80 off your first meal. And guess what? Included your free shipping. We gonna make sure it's free. Oh yeah, we gonna make sure it's free, but you know what? Restrictions apply. So make sure you go to HelloFresh.com and figure it out.
Not about to do that.
I ain't arguing with a bitch that smoke black and mild.
Don't. Because you're going to lose either way.
You're going to lose.
Because she going to flick it and then hit you in your face.
Don't argue with
her. I got burnt and swung on. It's a bit crazy.
With bitches.
You know who else I ain't about to argue with?
Who that?
Chick who got a lot of dirty clothes.
Ooh, bitch ain't even thought of a day to go change. Change my mind.
I'm talking about she'll pack them up and take them to a whole nother house, but she won't wash them all.
She waiting for her mama to wash them.
I ain't arguing with a bitch that wear a lime neo green wig in the morning and go to the stove. Like, that don't look right in the morning time, like with no makeup. Like, you got to be fully dressed to get over that. But like 11 o'clock, going to Busy Bees, it just don't look right.
Let me tell you who else I ain't arguing with.
Who?
If she get in the bed and she rub her feet together and they make any sound. Woman feet supposed to be silent, my nigga. I'm talking about if she get in the bed, she get in the bed and rub her feet together, they sound like computer love. Get your shit, put some socks on, get the fuck out of here.
Bitch, you cricket. You fucking a cricket now.
You fucking a fucking cricket. No noise. I'm not sticking around for that.
I ain't arguing with a bitch whose second toe longer than the big toe. Oh, if your second
the
toe
long
bigger
motherfucker.
If this toe bigger than that toe, I ain't arguing
that
with
that motherfucker look like this.
No.
I ain't arguing that bitch.
Her toe look like this. You like, bitch. Your bitch, them toes throw the deuce.
Tell you who else I ain't arguing with. If a chick got a lot of tattoos, but she got one she won't let nobody see, she be like, don't look at that. Not doing
it. I ain't arguing with a bitch that got the panther that skid down with the blood. You know what I'm talking about?
That panther long as hell now.
Y'all know which one I'm talking about? The Black Panther. This bitch was popping like in the early 2000s.
That was the Black Panther. That was the Pink Panther.
So you don't want to argue with her, because that bitch.
That motherfucker done went all the way over here.
My number one trigger tattoo. If you never seen the chick who get like the baby feet. Like on the birth certificate.
You talking about the Eve?
Like they had like the baby Eve footprints. Yeah, but they be like baby footprints.
In the middle of her chest?
I done seen that.
What the fuck?
It'd be like a birthday. It'd be like footprints, and then it'd be like a birthday, but you don't know if it's like a birthday or like they ain't make it day.
Damn. Yeah, I don't want to.
That was cold, boy. That was cold blooded. You look at him, stab you in the neck.
Don't argue no bitch that go to Boosie pool party.
Oh!
Don't argue with none of them hoes. Them bitches ready for whatever.
They gonna go crazy.
Don't argue with none of them hoes.
I'm gonna tell you the number one chick don't argue with.
Who?
If you get on her social media and her name is King Anything. Bitch a stud. Don't fuck with her. I'm talking about King with the Y instead of the I.
No. Yeah.
She believing herself way too much.
Way too much.
Hang up the phone! Hang up the phone.
We sitting there talking this shit, but I remember one time I quit fucking with a chick and she wanted to do 3 things in one day. Mm-mm-mm.
That's a lot. That's a lot at
she
over 30.
She wanted to do 3 things in one day?
She thought I'm gonna go outside 3 different times.
She nigga, wanna go outside.
I done had a bitch want to do 3 things at night. Like, bitch, where else you think we going?
Like, why do you want to keep going someday?
Hey, you know, you bitch talk, it's 3 o'clock, you bitch talking, it just got started. Bitch, hey, who it has it?
Duval, tell the truth. Them young chicks be so disappointed when you tell them y'all going home. Where we going now? To the house? Oh.
It's, bitch, we going home. Bitch, I don't give a fuck. Are you going to drop me off? Bitch, something.
They be so hurt over there. Oh, but let me text them and tell them where you go. Well, you need to go and do that, because we is at the crib, baby.
But is that the new thing, though? Like, motherfuckers just want to be out all the time?
Yes.
Nah, people always been out, because I remember used to coming out at 1:12 in the daytime. But after you do that shit for a couple years,
right,
shit play out.
I'm too right. old. Like,
I'm too late. I don't really give
nigga,
a fuck.
Nigga, let me
no
tell
kids.
You the hardest time for the club.
When?
It's like between 10 and 12 when you waiting to go.
Right.
Like, that shit is forever, because that's like when I doze off.
Right.
Because I ain't, like, before then, you had pre-gaming, because you got all your homeboys when you're young.
Right.
Hey. When you get old, it's just you and your old lady. And you be like, shit. I think I'm going to just watch the club from Instagram. I ain't really got to go. You know, because that's when you debating if you really want to go.
Right.
And then you start telling yourself shit that make you not want to go.
Like, you're like, man,
my
they
girl
be
finer than all them hoes.
Yeah, and then you be like, man, them niggas be busting in that bitch anyway, man. You know, these niggas don't know how to act.
Girl finer than all them hoes.
You know, you start acting like, man.
I got when, pussy at the crib, really.
When I don't want to go, I be trying to lie to nigga like, man, I don't know nobody at the door.
Right.
That's my line when I don't want to go.
Especially you fucking around
again. I just tell you straight up, I stay too far. Bluetooth, Harry. Uh-oh, somebody bitch been here before.
Oh, shit.
Bluetooth, Shawanda.
Bro, you fucking around and get half waiting on some niggas and go to sleep for real sleep like you ain't even know you was sleep till you wake up to about 4:15 in the morning.
Man.
38 missed calls, 16 texts. The last text say, nigga, we in the driveway.
I done had nigga to pull up. I see them and I just actually, I only pick up the phone, I'm just tired. I see them calls, they come to the door, I'm like, shit.
We well, lost the lighter.
I lost my phone.
Hell no.
It's good. This
you were just tweeting on that bitch.
I know, that bitch somewhere.
That old nigga
wrong.
Shit, that shit was in your lap.
This the other one. I don't know where that bitch went.
It didn't fall in the couch.
Yep, it fell right in the couch.
I told
we
you.
We got the old ass couch.
J-O-N, play me some pimping, man. We got living legends. Duval in here, rich broke.
Man, we just vibing decent, man. We ain't doing too much.
Hell yeah. Jackson.
I'm proud of y'all, man. Y'all doing y'all shit y'all own way.
Man. That's what we doing, man. Y'all we taking Marvin Gaye everywhere we go, man. You and this motherfucker looking like Marvin Gaye.
That, what about?
On that picture.
Right now?
That's supposed to be me?
Mm-mm. See, that's Marvin Gaye, nigga.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
But you said it was me, too.
And I said you was looking like him on that picture.
Oh, I look like him.
Yeah. Our picture finna fall. Y'all see that shit?
Nah, that's
I
just...
I thought that's how it was supposed to be.
See, it's a piece of wood in the middle of the picture holding the frame, so it's crooked like that.
For real?
Yeah. I was just letting the shit lean because we hold weight, though.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's oh, okay. One. Okay, that was a good analogy right there.
Hell yeah. You feel me? Jacksonville in this motherfucker, 904.
What are we talking about?
Man, let's see what's going on in this motherfucker. Tyler Perry is officially a billionaire now.
That nigga though.
But I'm gonna speak on behalf of Tyler Perry on this one.
What's up?
Because as a black man, I know that he didn't want everybody to know that.
Right. He definitely did.
Now, yep. This really, I didn't want to be the one to say it. But since it's already out, I'm just right. repeating it. Don't think that this is the official announcement.
Right.
Because as a black man, if you went up to Tyler Perry,
he's still gonna be like, man, go ahead. I ain't doing that, bro.
Not only is he
fucking around.
Ain't none of white folks
I ain't
here.
Fucking around.
What's most important than him being a billionaire is the fact that he has ownership. One of the only black people out here that own shit. You know what I'm saying? That's owning big shit. You know what I'm saying?
So crazy.
To me, that's bigger than being a billionaire.
Right.
You know?
Salute,
I'm about to
OG.
Take the Tyler Perry route with my comedy.
Shit, we all do it. I think I do it already.
I'm writing a play.
Everything I do, I own.
I'm writing a play.
What you talking
about? A street nigga that can sing real good, but he wanna write children's books.
That's dope.
So he conflicted in his Christian faith in the streets.
Right.
Because he a 100% street nigga, but he loved the Lord.
Right.
But he gifted with this art.
Right.
But in order to pursue these children books, he got to give up the streets or something.
Right.
Yeah. I've been working on my shit. Soon as I saw the
video. It's a play or is a musical?
I don't know. I'm thinking it got to be a play first, then a movie.
Do musical.
Do a musical?
Musical.
Yeah, he can already sing real good.
Come
he got
on,
a,
now.
A thug with a heart of gold.
Come on, now.
America is ready.
I love the kids.
America
I love
ready.
The kids.
They really are.
I can't take this shit no more, but I love the kids. I'm finna sell crack, but not in front of the kids.
That's on page 32. I was gonna get with your people about having you read for it.
Because
I didn't want to just assume you was gonna be with it.
Who? Me?
You, yeah.
Oh, hell yeah, I fought with it.
Oh, this how you know Tyler Perry's still a real nigga.
Talk your shit.
It says he's been declared officially a billionaire. He building a new house in East Atlanta.
Nigga went to the east side.
He been listening to Gucci.
Uh-huh. Bought a lot of land over
Because if you listen to Gucci, he make East Atlanta sound fun. Think about it. With a horse farm and an airplane landing strip. He just balling on y'all ass.
He had an airplane on that other, he had an airplane landing strip at his other house. The one that I think Steve Harvey just bought.
God
damn. That's some baller ass
Steve
shit.
Steve Harvey just bought a house?
He just bought, I think he bought Tyler Perry's old house that was in Peachtree.
Nigga, we're talking about, look, you buy my house while I buy this house.
Real player shit. When you buy an old celebrity house, that's how you know you got some bread.
Like Rick Ross did.
Right.
Yeah, because 50 Cent bought
Mike Tyson's
house.
He caught that one.
Yeah, that was a sweet look.
That
all
was that. Sweet.
I like the land that he got over there more than the house.
But you know they used to use that shit for like mansion parties and shit.
Yeah. He still do for his parties.
For real. Of course. His shit.
Shit, he shot Coming to America too at that bitch.
Yeah, he make money having
lit
that
it, lit, lit.
Smart. Shout out to
salute,
the biggest
boss. Shout out to goddamn Rick, man. He be going crazy.
Salute to Tyler Perry too. Salute to Dr. Dre. His wife won too. His ex-wife.
That ain't no salute.
Yeah, no. This
that nigga
crazy.
Need a hug.
His ex-wife won $2 million
fuck,
a month.
Man. Come give me a hug, doctor.
I saw that. She said she needed
$900,000. That nigga named Dr. Dre going through all the shit.
Is that the one where she said she needed $900,000 in entertainment?
Yeah.
What about the one where they said for the Wi-Fi? What it was like, $20,000 for Wi-Fi?
20 G's.
Well, I'd be up there with the
ass
for $15,000, but
every month?
I don't know what she doing for it, but $900,000 a month.
And how much, and she said it was a big number for her phone bill, right?
Like 20 G's a month.
What phone?
Yeah, 20,000 a month.
For
what
the phone
bill costs? What email costs?
What they phone say, bill costs 20,000?
That's what you say for emails and phone bill is 20,000 a month.
What the fuck is she doing?
I don't know.
I mind my business, man, but that's ridiculous.
Yeah, so I just
want understanding. That's all.
That's ridiculous. Then they talking about you got to keep them up by living the. They got to keep themselves up if they like to live it. Keep it up.
Bruh.
And since you like it, keep it up.
Every day in 2020 has been interesting.
Run. Why I got to run for you?
Hey, Tamar Braxton, stay in the news.
What's wrong with Tamar?
Man. Last week, she was something. Now, this week, her boyfriend put a restraining order, said she been beating on him.
Man, I don't think Tamar like that, man. He just can't fight.
No. She was whooping
it
that
got
nigga.
Got to be, bro. A nigga, if a nigga put a restraining order out on you, man, that mean he I'm tired, woman. He one of them niggas. I'm tired.
He been holding her down while she was going through her little her sick spell.
Right.
Right.
And then now he like, oh nah. For a motherfucker to go from holding you down to say, nah, this is too much. That says a lot about that person. That's all I'm gonna say.
She might have whooped his ass. I don't know.
Yeah, when you, cause after a while you be like, you know how you with a girl and you be with her for a while, you be like, oh no, nah, this bitch
right.
crazy.
Right.
For but real.
You might have had that part, cause sometimes it take one thing, you be like, oh nah, they ain't bullshitting. That's it be like that. And they ever be like, I told you. That's how it be.
I don't think she throwed out like that though.
Man. I mean,
man.
Everybody can't be lying.
I like this black news because it's good news too. Man,
shit. I mean, I see why you say that. It sounds
and Tiana Taylor yeah. had another baby in the bathroom.
Say what?
Amon Shumpert and Tiana Taylor.
They say Erykah Badu had the baby for her too. That's dope. Ooh,
yeah, but they said they had the baby in the bathroom. Man.
Yeah, natural. Whoa. She did it in the bathroom. Erykah Badu.
That they did that on purpose.
Yeah.
They tried to make it seem like the shit happened randomly.
They did it. It's a natural thing.
It's a house mom.
She was the doula.
Cause she's certified, right? Erykah Badu is certified.
Yeah, she's a doula.
Midwife, that's what it is. Midwife. I'm talking about house mom.
It's called a doula.
What's like house mom.
That's the lady that gets you ready
to
have a baby.
Oh, Badula. Oh.
Come on, I know some shit now.
Who?
Badula.
She's the doula. Yeah.
That's hard.
That's fine. When I have my next baby, you gonna deliver it for me. I gotta get Badula.
Did y'all hear that R. Kelly got beat up by a white dude?
That shit was funny. That's I wanna see footage.
That's crazy.
I wish.
The crazy part, it was protesting why he did it.
Right.
The reason why he did it, because they was protesting outside for R. Kelly.
They had the jail on lockdown.
They had the jail on lockdown. He was like, and he got mad and wanted to buck on him.
Yeah, but that dude had, the dude that they showed the picture of, this nigga had like 17 tattooed teardrops in his face. Right.
Trying to get R. Kelly.
That's normal, nah.
Right.
I don't think that means.
That shit don't mean nothing. Niggas just like teardrop. Yeah. Niggas just want some raindrops under his eye. He don't look like he crying for life.
Hey man,
he's sad.
The entire Rochester Police Department is resigning.
They left? Yeah. How you know something up when niggas just be leave, like, hey man, we gotta go. They can't fuck with it, we ain't working no more.
That nigga said, like, out of all the stuff on that paper, he said, you know it's Rochester.
The police said, fuck it.
So what niggas gonna do when niggas break in their house? Who they gonna call?
I do. The Ghostbusters, I guess.
Call the bounty hunter. They gotta call somebody.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
The bounty hunter.
Who? Shit, niggas know this here. When they, niggas wasn't really doing nothing here for a while. And niggas was like, all right, we need these police back. But these niggas is bucking on us.
Damn. I was wondering, does anybody know the black dude who dressed up like Obama that let Trump cuss him out and call him a monkey? Does anybody know any of his cousins or anything?
I'm talking about niggas sat right there. That's a good pick. All right.
Listen here, you black monkey.
He said that shit too?
I'm sure he did.
Oh. I about to say, damn!
Let's move on to
something. He said, little nigga, no, he don't give a fuck.
Let's move on to something more positive. 19 black families buy over 97 acres of land to create a safe city for black people.
Good shit.
Possibly the new Black Wall Street.
Good shit.
They calling it Freedom, Georgia.
Don't make it the new Black Wall Street because they burnt that bitch down.
Right.
Make it what they say they calling it?
Freedom, Georgia.
Call it Freedom, Georgia.
We got to
have
them on
the
show.
Freedom, Georgia.
Bring them on the show.
We
got
to bring them on the show.
How many? We got to bring out 19 families?
We'll just bring like a representative.
She's going to be like, all right.
How you fucking up shit? I'll buy some of
that. Family number one. All right. Man, these motherfuckers taking pictures like a motherfucker, man. They done brought everybody. You know they done brought their grandma. She's still in the car. He like, God damn. Grandma, y'all done killed grandma in the car.
I heard this shit about an hour and a half away from me. I don't know how far it is. Can somebody, research department, tell me how far
I hope
far
they ain't by that little spot that
it's
everybody
not
was
too
looking
far.
At.
Toonsboro.
That little town.
That little thing we went to go look
that
at.
Town.
Oh, man, that shit. I ain't gonna say nothing. Y'all gonna get that bitch right.
They bought that town?
They bought that town. They better have a good plan for it, cause boy, that motherfucker, though. But I believe in shit. If they bought it, I bet they had a plan. So shit, I'm down for it.
If they don't like it, I'll buy it from them for less than nothing, though. I ain't buying it for what they paid.
But I know they paid because they wanted 2.5 then. They probably talked about like 1.8.
Duncan already plotting on the real estate?
No, I'm saying I buy from him that way he can flip it back, stay back in the black community.
I like how you're thinking. That's rich broke shit.
Come on now. Just like you do in the hood when you when niggas get all the shit and they gotta go to jail.
Yeah.
Don't you buy it from for the load? Where you get all your cars from?
Shit, people doing bad.
Niggas doing bad.
Niggas doing bad.
Shit, that's the American way.
Yeah. I'm here to help.
Shit, you
I don't never think I'm taking advantage. I'm here to help.
Damn, I'm here to help a motherfucker, but I
120 miles from Atlanta.
That's what bail bondsmen do. That's what
Storage Wars do.
Yeah, Storage Wars. What the pawn shop do?
Got
when you're going bad, they get you what you need. Not what you want, you're going to get what you need.
Exactamundo. Tombsboro. So shout out to them people, man, who made that happen. That's a hell of a play.
Y'all boy did y'all thing.
I would do it for, in my idea, I would use it for something else, though.
But what it is, though,
Yeah, let's talk that shit.
It is enough for them to start if they have a functional objective.
Yes, sir. I believe that. That's what I saw too.
You see what I'm saying?
Like what my idea
you
for
really
it,
can't go.
What my idea was for it, it would have worked.
Right.
Because I didn't need that much to fix. It would have been dope.
But no, so we went down there hands-on and really actually was just like walking on the premises and problems and shit. And it was just like, all right, you could tell that this motherfucker who probably been had it, who ain't even touched it since the 60s.
They did a 70s. TV show about that on Netflix. Y'all seen that? Saying? Where he bought this town and they got fucked up, so they ended up having to move to this town and start that shit over.
Right. And then the crazy part about it, they had one sheriff in them, three over the whole time. They were black. So it's like, you really can start some shit if you really want to go down there and just, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Got to get on the political side and then really
take time.
Get the shit right.
That's what I'm going to do.
They know what they're doing.
You got me a whole bunch of acres and shit.
I
ain't bought no land in Mississippi yet.
Oh, yeah.
That shit actually high as fuck.
I've been looking at Alabama. I seen a house for like $17,000.
But who wants to live in Alabama?
It wasn't even that. It was just bought. Just to have it. Just to have property, just in case shit go wrong, goddammit, moving to Alabama.
Listen here, I buy all my property in Georgia.
Just only in Georgia?
Well, even for the moment. I ain't found shit in Mississippi. I told you shit.
Buy some shit out the country.
You gotta buy.
If you don't learn.
I want to go to Bahama.
You should definitely buy some shit in Bahamas. Buy some shit out the country. That way you ain't gotta pay no taxes.
Right.
No property taxes.
Right. Well, you really live in free. Yours. Forever. I've been telling
and
the nigga
it's a
that
lot
shit,
less
bro.
Too.
I've been
and
telling
it's a lot
him that.
Less. You can go like to Honduras and get some shit.
You got your dual citizenship?
I should have been dated, but I never dated because it was so. Only place I would get in the Bahamas, but I've been there so much, I really didn't need nothing.
Right.
Unless only reason I was going to get it just a stunt to say I got dual citizenship, but I really didn't need it.
But you gotta think about doing citizenship, nigga. You can get the fuck away from over here, man. I mean, be gone.
I can get the fuck away from over here now.
I know that, but I'm saying like it be gone without having a limit amount of time to be gone.
Even with that, like if I really wanted to be gone, see the thing about it ain't hard to leave. It's hard to get back in this motherfucker.
Yes, that's the thing.
You can go. You can get the hell on, and don't get it twisted. Ain't no place on earth better than America.
Right.
America's good. This the only.
I tell motherfuckers.
This the only place where a nigga can come from nothing and be something still. Ain't too many places where niggas going from where we from or where you grew up at or where I grew up at or where he grew up at and becoming millionaires.
Right.
And what other country you heard from that? From
but you can broaden your horizons and start. I know other countries is definitely better than this shit.
Nah, this shit is great, man.
But this only great for working opportunities, though.
Nigga, that's what it's here for. What else
but
you
that's
want?
What I said. Other than that, I mean,
it's
that ain't
great.
Nothing.
Like, why you
it's
think
more
than
life
people,
than just
why
working.
You think more than, why you think people from other countries come here and come up? Because they see the opportunity.
I'm going to tell you what make America different from everywhere else is you can literally make it here doing some bullshit.
You can make it here.
That's
you
why
can be
other people
up.
Be like, oh my God, he made it doing this.
Right.
If I was there, I would do this and this is all I would do.
I ain't say that either. I said this is a working country. Other than that.
Not working, not how I'm working and them other motherfuckers work for 10 cents a day.
I ain't going over there to work.
Shit, that's working.
But I ain't going over there to work. I go over there to live, but make my money here. Right.
And that's
you see what
do.
I'm saying? But that's what I'm saying. I go over there and live, but make my money here.
I would.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. But I don't know, but see the American creature comforts that we used to.
Right.
you ain't gonna have them over there.
Right.
And like just think at the end, middle of the night, you wanna go to Walmart. You can do that. You can't do that after six. When they get dark where I live
I know it.
If you ain't got what you need, you ain't got it.
But you know, some shit, that, I mean.
And sometimes the internet go out, everything go out on my island. And you just chilling.
Right.
So if you don't know how to just chill.
But see,
like
you
that,
got your island.
But that's what I'm saying. So certain places, you gotta know where, like it's certain places that's a little more Americanized
right,
and shit.
Right,
that's,
right, right.
But certain places, like where we think like, shit, I'm gonna chill and just, you gotta be really ready for that.
No, that's what I'm saying. I'm a chill ass nigga, bro. That's why a lot of shit, I don't need all that loud ass shit. I would literally be ducked off in Bahamas, old nigga.
I wanna see you come to my spot for like 2 weeks.
Back.
Off the grid.
Off the grid. Off the I'm grid talking about all the way, but you know, chilling is all the way.
That's
take
what I'm saying.
Yeah, dude.
Chilling. I'm serious. I want to see him. How long you think he gonna last?
4 days. Hey, Kat, can you see DC soon? And he try to goddamn reach somebody and they fall into work. Man, fuck, man.
I don't need to reach nobody.
You miss
the fuck
money
I need
like
to talk?
A...
Who I need to talk to? Cause if I'm chilling for 2 weeks, shit, I already secured. Dig what I'm saying? You only chill because you ain't worried about nothing.
But just like you said,
dig what I'm saying?
Them discomforts will make me so discomfort.
Now, I'm chill and I need some of them creature comforts.
Right.
So I know
see,
if
but
a
I
young
understand.
Nigga like you,
but see,
you'll go crazy. I go crazy sometimes when the internet be, like sometimes my water might not cut on sometimes. This is an island living
it's a,
for
it's
real.
A lot of shit that we just can't just go and do.
I don't know if your skin, like the sand flies, that's what they don't show you on these Instagram pics. The goddamn sand flies and the mosquitoes tearing your motherfucking ass up in paradise.
No.
By the third day, you ever watch Naked and Afraid?
Can I get another plate?
But them motherfuckers be quitting because the mosquitoes bit them.
That shit hurt,
nigga.
No.
But my body immune to it, so it don't bite me like that.
Bro, I can't believe you ain't set your water bill on auto pay by now.
For what? No, when the pandemic happened, I cut all that shit off because I was like, fuck that, I need all my money.
What?
I cut all my auto pay off.
For real?
Damn right, I pay it when I get it.
Ah, my boy.
Shit.
Oh, no, I don't want the fry. You loaded them up? Oh, he loaded them
look
up.
Good. What's that? Where you got that from, out there?
Yeah, yeah. That's this spot. Y'all got a regular fry?
Yeah, you want that?
Yeah, regular fry.
Where the menu at?
Hey, bro. That shit. Bust! See, that one time I'm an islander, bro. I can eat shrimp steak all day, bro. I be chilling, bro. As long as
fishing?
I got my necessity shit.
You
I be, nigga,
what's
I,
up?
I
right,
fish.
Let me
listen,
right,
that's
well,
a piece of mind. I'm an old nigga.
Let me
I
ask
just
you
do this,
this
shit.
All right,
this
but let
shit
me ask you this.
It's a piece of mind.
What's five things you need?
Five things I need.
To survive.
To survive.
Yeah. Outside your family and all that, but I'm saying like for your own personal creature comforts, what's five things you need?
I need a knife. I need a baby get something off me. As long as I get something off me, I'm all right, good.
All right, FOMO.
I need a knife.
FOMO.
And this, I'm kicking it. What you talking about? To survive or did
just
me?
Just kicking it. Just chilling. You ain't. Mm. We not in Naked and Afraid where you trying to cook.
No, I
need a skillet.
I need my tent.
Gotta have a fire stick.
I got to have a tent, goddamn.
No, you gonna stay in the house. So you going to the extreme.
Okay. Bit.
Yeah, not that extreme.
Five. I gotta have my knife. Uh-huh. I really don't need it, but just to have some type of access, to have some type of communication on the outside. Gotta have a phone.
Okay.
All right. Weed.
Okay.
Gotta have some hoe.
Okay.
You dig what I'm saying?
You're right.
And then after that, shout it. We gotta have a little bread to just maneuver.
That's all I do.
I'm
good. This is all you need. This
I'm
all
good.
You said most of the shit you need.
Right.
You gotta have at least a woman. You can't just be on that motherfucking body. You gotta have some pussy.
Right.
Pussy.
Right.
Drugs.
Right.
Pussy, drugs.
Right. Look, that's all you need.
I gotta have a no.
Pussy, drug.
I gotta have camera.
Drug.
A camera, like a phone, to be able to do the fun shit, like to
navigate, you know what I'm
not
saying?
Even navigate, just to take pictures and
just record yourself.
Record me with
proof
the bitches.
Of existence, motherfucker.
No, for afterwards when I tell y'all, when I let y'all know what happened.
Right, right, right.
So
right.
I need that.
Right.
What else I said? Money.
You said money and drugs, nigga. You said pussy, drugs, and phones.
And a boat.
Need a boat? Need a boat.
Yes.
So need a boat?
Yes, because we're going to go have fun on the boat, swimming and fishing.
I mean, but that's a part of the ensemble, the boat and fishing.
Okay.
You feel me? Nigga, I barbecue, take the hot dogs and shit on the boat.
Well,
me
I only need three things then. I need Wi-Fi.
You bullshit.
Did I say Wi-Fi?
Mm-mm.
Oh, I definitely need Wi-Fi.
I mean, that's part of the phone ensemble, though.
I definitely need Wi-Fi. Like, that's what, I don't give a fuck where I go. If it ain't no Wi-Fi there,
bro, I'm a real islander, bro. Fun. I'm a real islander, bro. Once I tap in, I'm tapped in.
I'm like, what island have you been on that was just straight chill?
That was just straight chill?
Like, yeah, not no tourists yet.
Turks and Caicos. Straight. I'm talking about people weren't even outside like that, my nigga. At the beach, it was like,
Turks and Caicos, it was
like 10 people at the
that's
beach,
like
nigga.
That's like one of the romantic islands.
Maybe it was like 10 people at the beach, nigga. I'm like, nigga, shit peaceful. I'm just sitting out the aisles, thugging.
The most
cooling.
What's Bermuda.
Bermuda?
It wasn't shit going on in Bermuda.
Bermuda lit though.
It was lit, but I'm saying it's
shit, far I've been on that. I done been
I couldn't have been there a long time.
Right, no.
What
mean,
was that, like 4 days?
4 or 5 days. But see, one thing about Bermuda it is, it's you just got to know somebody. Hey man, guess what? There was no better place to get in on all of the action better than DraftKings, you dig? The leader in one-day fantasy sports. Hey man, guess what, man? To add to this week's excitement, DraftKings got about what? A couple $1 million in prizes. Hey man, if you haven't tried out DraftKings yet, head on over there to the App Store and go on and download that app. You don't want to miss it. Uh-oh, every run, every pass, every catch means more with the DraftKings, man. All you gotta do is pick your lineup and stay real small up under your salary cap, and guess what? You're gonna see that money stack up against your competition. DraftKings done paid out millions of dollars. They paid out what? Yeah, man, y'all better go sign up, because you don't want to miss that. They done paid out millions of dollars since 2012, so they know a little thing, but you know what I'm saying? They know a little thing or two. Cook. I'm gonna download that shit right now. Guess what you can do, man? Go on over there to DraftKings right now, download the app, use the code 85SOUTH, and for a limited time, new users can get a chance to win millions of dollars in prizes this week. So you know what? You don't want to miss week 2 action, okay? So go on over to DraftKings right now. Download the app. Use the code 85SOUTH. And you can get a chance to win millions of dollars off your first deposit, okay? With the code 85SOUTH. So don't miss that shot, my man. Handle your bid. You did. Boom! Uh-oh. Draft your lineup now and feel the sweat like you never did before.
You just can't be that like shit.
But if you, that's what I'm saying. Like, if you don't know nobody, it looks like ain't nobody on that goddamn island.
And it's literally like 2 stores that everybody eat and shop in.
But if you jump in the car, go down the street, make 2 lefts, it'd be 500 motherfuckers over there.
Hmm. One way in, one way out.
Yeah.
Thugging. Nah, they treat us good in Bermuda. Yeah. But nah, I'm a real island though, bro.
I had a lot of fun.
I'm just not deep sea fishing with the sharks though.
You don't like the water?
I love the water, but I just ain't playing with death like that.
That ain't playing with death.
You playing with death.
That ain't playing
I
with
play
death.
With like a little land shark. I got to get, let me crawl before I walk. I wouldn't say I wouldn't do it. Yeah, let me crawl before I walk.
Yeah, okay.
Put me with a little land shark first.
What
let
you
me,
be with a nurse shark?
I want to get
a nurse shark.
Yeah, I want to go in there and play
the
with
one. The one that look like catfish?
Yeah.
He want to be with them motherfuckers. They don't even bite.
Yeah, I want to play with them. Then we get the bigger ones. You know what I'm saying? Go by the stingray, because you know you can die from stingray. Go fuck around. I. Take me to the one that y'all know that
I
like him.
I fuck with the shark for the stingray.
We done seen the shark.
Yeah, the stingray. I ain't.
You seen some shit?
I ain't too much know too much about them like that.
Right.
I mean, I done did the whole thing to act. You know, one time say, all right, let me take a picture with them.
Right.
But I ain't fucking around like in normal population. Ocean.
The shit you had done did it was like, all right, I ain't gonna lie, that motivated me to want to do that shit. When you sat right there and had all them sharks. You had like 30 of them bitches. I was like,
that's
my
whole purpose of doing it, man.
To
get us to do more shit. Because you are what you see, and it opens your mind up. So I try to do stuff for people that's like me. Because if you see a white man do it, or somebody that don't look like you do it, you don't pay it no attention. But when you see somebody else do it, you be like, man, I'm finna do that. Right. Or just like with housing and buying land. When you see niggas like that buying land, makes you want to do it.
Right.
Just like when you see me buying a plane and say, shit, I probably do need it. Like when you came to me that time, you was like,
shit, so how much you got the plane for? It makes you inquisitive.
And I still been thinking about it too.
Because you see the business in it.
Yeah, yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
I see the motherfucking expenses in it.
And you see how you save money.
Right.
People think you balling, but it's really you doing it for business and you save money. It's good for taxes and all
right,
that.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? Because you can write it off.
Right.
Because it's a part of your fucking business. It's
fucking
a,
right.
I ain't gonna front. It takes a lot of money though, but
yes, sir.
You're gonna spend that money on taxes anyway. You might as well put it in that.
Might as well.
For real.
You just dropped some game and some business all in one conversation. I hope I was just sitting here just listening, and I hope they.
Because I'm high right now.
Me, I'm high too, and I'm like,
and I've been
y'all
telling my nigga he need to get that island. Like, see, he don't like the water. He want a whole nigga. You ain't gonna see him in no
you
tank
know what?
Top.
We need to do an 85 South show.
He don't like it body.
We need to do an 85 South show at my house. A getaway at the house.
What?
Just at my house in the Bahamas, whenever they open that bitch back up.
Because they
got it where it's quarantined. You got to stay there for 14 days in the same spot.
But ain't it warm at the end of the year in Bahamas?
It's warm all year round. But I'm saying, like, we just need to go so y'all can get the feel, give y'all audience a feel of the vibe of peace within. So you can vibe with everything.
Because don't you got to drive your boat to your island?
Nah, I fly my plane out there. You can fly private. They used to do commercial flight once a week, but since this shit happened, they shut that shit down.
You can't even go to your house.
Yeah.
But if you had to do a citizenship,
that's the only thing. Nah, I can still do it now. It's just I gotta sit there and
for 14 days.
Yeah, and I don't want to feel like I'm in jail.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
These niggas told me I can't leave. Yeah. Right. Yeah. No. Mm-mm. You're a grown ass man.
Yeah.
That's the thing though. Like you said, it's hard to get back in. I always be thinking they ain't gonna let me back in for some reason.
Yeah, it's they don't bullshit getting in this motherfucker.
Like, why they do that?
Man, America don't America play
ain't
about
no,
that
America
bullshit.
Ain't no joke, bro. We think it because we take it for granted. Right. But shit. Why you think the motherfuckers be sneaking over to try to get over this motherfucker? The motherfuckers be coming in all time. They don't just walk in this bitch. They try to get
it's
in.
It's very rare to
and that tell you how good it is here.
Man. You don't, that's what I'm saying. You don't hear black people tell you how good it is around this A, man.
Shit.
You gotta leave the bed and look it back and be like, man, we got it good over there. We can get fat. Yeah. Being able to live in a country where you can get fat if you want to.
If you want
that
to.
That is the biggest flex. You can eat anytime you want to. You can just wake up, bust a left, be right at the goddamn Waffle House.
Put it this way.
24 hours.
We live in a country where we can complain and not get killed for it.
That's the biggest flex.
Now, that's probably the biggest shit we got.
You know what I'm saying? Like
we the only country that can like cuss out our president.
We can cuss out our president.
And won't shit.
Man, I was in the Philippines. You think Trump, he made Trump look like the Pope, the president of Philippines.
Was it Hugo Chavez?
I don't know. This motherfucker here, his son got arrested for drugs. He said if he come find out that his son was doing that, he gonna kill him himself.
Hold on, what's his name?
Rodrigo Duterte. You see it on there?
Am I not? He said what now?
Rodrigo Duterte.
This nigga for his campaign, he threw a motherfucker out the helicopter. No.
Who?
He did.
Rodrigo Duterte.
Say his name again. He a gangster for real. He made it martial law. If you see somebody, you can shoot them straight up. This is the wildest shit, though, and it's fucked up.
And this in Honduras?
Huh?
That's in what?
Nah, that's in the Philippines. He just did some wild shit, though.
What year that war?
He doing it right now. But guess what? Ain't no crime at that bitch. Ain't never been a crime like that.
There's no crime?
Nigga, I done been to countries where they say if you get caught with, that's the only place, when I go over there on the east side of the world, I don't fuck around with weed shit.
Uh-huh.
They got a place, not in Dubai, I was in, I think Indonesia, if you get caught with drugs, the penalty is death.
Die. Yeah.
Like, I ain't fucking around. Shit,
it
me.
Ain't worth it.
Not for no blood.
Shit, me, man, we got it good over here.
I would be over there 2 weeks sober hell, but I'm having a great time.
Yeah, America lit than a motherfucker.
This motherfucker's lit.
We got time to complain.
The drugs will bring me back. Like I got to come back and smoke a blunt.
And it's gonna eventually get like that. That's why once we understand who we at, by the time it get like that, we good.
Oh, the dude is a boxer or some shit. He a wrestler.
Say it again, read it to me.
Let me see.
What happened, John?
It's the Iranian wrestling champ. They got him, he's about to get executed. They said he had a role in a 2018 protest against the government. Mm.
He about to get executed?
For the shit we do all the time, marching.
Hold up.
And protesting.
He about to get executed for in what country?
And they probably gonna publicize it and make him an example. They gonna make an example.
But he was a wrestler.
And they gonna talk shit after they do it. He was the wrestling champ. But no man is stronger than me. The law is the law and no one is above the law. Then he gonna say a bunch of shit that we don't understand. I'm not gonna say it because I don't wanna offend nobody.
Yeah, I was ready to go to another, let's go to another topic.
Them niggas will show up. No, let's discuss what you said, my friend.
No, don't discuss it. I agree. I see why y'all did what y'all did.
No, look at my face when I talk to you, when you talk to me. Look at my face, you want to talk? Yeah, them motherfuckers don't play. Show up smelling like baby powder.
They who?
Them rich motherfuckers show up smelling just like baby powder. They bring in extra motherfuckers who ain't got nothing to do with it.
Nigga, we got it so good, we can sit here and just talk shit and make money.
And ain't nobody gonna do shit
to fuck in the middle of a pandemic.
Freedom of speech. I remember when they didn't used to let niggas talk in public. That's why I get on this bitch and show my ass every time they turn the camera on. Because they wouldn't even let my granddaddy talk shit in public.
Come on, man.
Niggas couldn't even sit 3 deep nowhere. They could just take everybody. Hey. What you think loitering means? We don't want no niggas around here.
Mm-hmm. Where that shit came from? Standing around. Mm-hmm. Shit, we had to stand somewhere. We ain't invited in. They don't even want a nigga on the curb. You in the street. I mean, we on the grass. Get off the grass. These niggas don't want us floating. They just want us to float. I don't know how to float, big dog.
Hey, I wonder if some niggas ever stopped a white man from drinking out the colored only water fountain.
Hey.
Whoa, what you doing, bro? Whoa.
You made for your lips.
Leave that shit alone. Your shit is up the hall.
Take all that war. That nigga here stupid.
Hey man, can I use your bathroom? The white only bathroom is full right now. I gotta poo poo real bad.
You gonna shit on yourself.
No,
you gonna shit on yourself.
Sir. Ain't nobody dropping no stinking load in here if you ain't a colored person. Colored only. You just go ahead to wait in line. I wish you the best.
Hey, man.
Oh, shit. That's
this shit right
stupid.
Here.
That's how I know I'm high. I think of the dumbest shit when I'm high. Stupid shit. Play some music, man. It's quiet in this bitch. Everybody blow.
This shit here out of
this is a blessing, man.
It is.
This shit here out of chain.
Y'all don't smoke back there?
They at work.
Oh, they can't smoke on the job?
Man, we take this shit serious. And we drug test them.
Y'all drug test them?
Yeah. Yeah. We gotta know how high the THC is.
Yeah.
Y'all got a menu for that? What? You got a menu for that?
Hey, boy.
Can I check it out?
I mean, all we got is shrimp back.
Oh, just shrimp.
Yeah, just for the dish.
You know what's crazy? I don't eat seafood.
I don't blame you.
Only thing I do eat, like I eat, like when I'm on the island, like I eat grouper. I like grouper and
wahoo. Oh, you gotta eat that red snapper.
Wahoo. You ever had wahoo? That shit tastes like chicken.
Wahoo?
Yes. No, dead serious. Like,
it's a fish?
It's a fish.
And it tastes wahoo? Like chicken.
Yeah, wahoo. I started eating it when I was in
wahoo.
Roatan.
Everybody ain't got that Roatan.
What is that?
Grouper tastes like chicken too.
Like, if it's like cooked, right?
Y'all don't fuck grouper. I eat a tuna steak.
Nah, I like snapper.
Hold up,
snapper
man. Somebody tell me what the fuck snapper. Roatan is. Yes, what is that?
Honduras.
Oh, okay, bet. Never mind. Delete the
snapper. Ryan, you got some people over there in Honduras, huh?
Where you from, man?
Niggas at Miami.
Where your people's from, nigga?
Vietnam. Oh, shit, my bad.
He didn't want to say it on camera.
Hey, don't you hate what motherfucker, you tell motherfucker you from somewhere, he be like, you know TV John?
hey, bleep that out. I don't want
y'all. All the Vietnam, he would bump into TV
John. He don't want everybody to know where he from. I had to force some of his paperwork so he could stay.
Oh, okay. Oh, really? Shit real around here. He ain't been telling nobody. That's, I get it now. You ain't supposed
to see, he ain't want to say Miami.
Miami.
Nah, where you people from? Man. How the fuck? They from somewhere else.
We need to figure out why TV John ain't learned English yet. You been here long? How long you been here?
The whole time.
You can say you got your green card. You good, bro.
He was born here.
Hey, right now Trump ain't got, he got too much shit going on to pay attention to you right now.
Man.
How long you been here?
Don't zoom in on him.
6 years.
You been here 6 years, nigga?
No, he been here 6 years. He just
I thought you been here.
No, he been here six years. He been real with me. Oh. I bring the real out. So,
man,
hey.
Stop talking to him. You're gonna get his paperwork fucked up, man.
Y'all gonna edit this part, right?
Joe an asshole. He ain't cut nothing out.
Yeah. He'll put that shit up. 6 years,
what's
Vietnam.
What's your social security number? 8871. Man, delete some of this shit.
All I said was, DC was talking. I want to hear what he was saying.
Look how high he is.
This thing is making a beat up there by himself.
He think he in here by himself. That's how high he is, man. I'm telling you, that nigga go.
Every time I look
that?
Over there, it feel like 98. Like 1998. Don't he look like a nigga from 19? Look at that one goal on the side. That's
he got one on each side.
He got that one goal on
the
side.
He a hot boy.
Yeah. Nigga got the Turk goals. The little Turk goals.
He look like he ready to go to a party, lean up against the wall and do this on a bitch, y'all, man.
Ah, you stupid.
Type of nigga who turn up when that Fifth Ward Weaver come on. Wop, baby, wop, 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 baby. Wop, wop, baby, come on, baby. Wait a minute. That nigga turn up to some Fifth Ward Weaver. Rest in peace, Fifth Ward Weaver, man.
OG.
It's my nigga now. Man, you from Florida. What made you move to Atlanta, man?
Hey.
Shit, comedy? Not even just comedy, just knew I had to get out of Jacksonville if I wanted to be somebody.
Man, I know that shit is right.
And that was 96. Before all this shit.
How old?
96, during the Olympics, I moved. During
how old
the
you
Olympics.
Were then?
19.
Damn, I was four.
I stayed in Jacksonville for a year after I graduated. And I was in that motherfucker. I was really in the streets, and I was like, nah, I gotta get up. That comedy shit saved my life from being up here.
What?
Because everybody else that was with me, they all got either knocked off or passed on. Damn. You know?
Shit real out here in these streets.
It's always gonna be real, you know? It's always gonna be real. It's just what you do with the game you got, with the cards you dealt.
Right. Okay, you damn sure can win.
Yeah, we all can win. Like I said, motherfucker come from nothing. Motherfucker come from a whole nother country where it wasn't no electricity to become a millionaire. We can do it right here from the trap.
Right. You know? Exactly.
We just got to tap into that mindset.
Yeah. Hey. We are. We got it. Shit.
We do.
Young niggas blitz. Making money more than we did.
We blitz.
In the industry, you know? Shit, niggas playing with some money now.
Right. Now they got to understand what...
When this shit happened?
Oh, it passed you?
Ain't nobody told me a motherfucker.
I say young niggas playing with money. It skipped us. We the artists that paid the price.
Oh, yeah.
Shit, they money out here, everybody getting it.
They still owe me for what they did to the cold crush.
That's what I tell niggas all the time. I'm overcharging niggas for what they did to the cold crush.
Hey, I'm still mad at
I'm overcharging
boy.
Niggas for what they did to. Too? For what they did to goddamn Bruce and all the OGs in there.
Mm. What?
Nothing, I'm just saying they worked hard. They had to get on the road and do the Chitlin Circuit and work hard. So now I'm overcharging for the people that paved the way for us. And then y'all overcharge for niggas like me. You see what I'm saying?
Some of them stories I don't be believing though.
Like what?
Sometimes niggas, like old niggas get to telling stories and they be forgetting that you done heard them sometimes. And like they start exaggerating. Like, nigga, I remember one time we drove 8 hours.
Shit, I did.
And split $40. I was like, why the fuck y'all do that? No. Why the fuck did y'all do that?
Nigga, I used to be tired of them driver.
Word.
Just like that's how I used to get paid on the road, because they ain't none of them niggas had cars.
Right.
I was the only nigga with a car. I had like a Crown Vic, you know, police version. We used to drive that motherfucker to Alabama, everywhere. Right. I make $500 and they give me 5 minutes on the stage.
Going crazy.
But in my mind, I got $500 to do a show.
Right.
So shit, it was a win for me. But I lose it because I get a ticket, so I'm in the rear.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? For speed. So shit, but that's how a nigga used to be on the road. But how I used to make your money is You do city to city. That's why I call it the Chitlin Circuit.
Right.
You do all them cities, you fuck around, have a stack.
Right.
Or 1,500, you know? So, and back then, that was better than goddamn working a job.
Right.
Hell yeah.
You know?
You can have a hell of a weekend.
Hell of a weekend.
Right. Just hit a different comedy spot.
You can come back home with five bands, you know? I'm talking about that just in the beginning stages. Once I started doing my own shit, it was on after that.
It was a wrap.
Yeah.
Take off. Never look back.
Look at these niggas talking that old comedy shit. Yeah, you know once we start.
Now, you know you had the
most. Talking that old shit. I don't even like talking the old shit.
I guess we could say it now, but it ain't been that long. You gon' like, when it's all said and done, you had one of the most legendary comedy nights in the whole country.
Trippin' on Tuesday.
It'd be stupid for you to come on here with the comedians and me not ask you and bring up Trippin' on Tuesday. Right. That shit was a staple.
Motherfuckers still talking
about it. It really made the Atlanta Uptown Comedy Club be known as that club.
It was a vibe, man. It was like something that you can't duplicate. You know what I'm saying? Because it had all the comedians and
right.
It had all the industry. It had everything. It was. Shit, it was Def Comedy Jam in Atlanta. You
right.
know what I'm saying?
Just every Tuesday.
Every Tuesday. And you had every celebrity, any celebrity you could think of, they came to it. And they participated in it. You know what I'm saying? We used to do the fake orgasm contest. That's when women was okay with having a good time and doing crazy
right.
shit. You know what I'm saying? So it was just dope. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people came up out of it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Shit, you came up through that them shits. Because people, you couldn't just get on stage, neither. They were booing the shit out of you.
Right,
man.
Right.
Do they boo niggas still?
No.
Niggas don't get booed?
Yeah. I think.
College show.
No.
I'm kid wild hair. Boo!
They don't really count, though.
Now,
what's wrong with you? Boo!
But see, it's a few colleges that are known for doing that.
Listen,
like,
they will
I ain't
boo
gonna
your
say
ass.
What they are because they it's the same college where it's like if they love you, they show you the most love.
Yes, sir.
But out of every show they have, somebody gonna catch it.
Yes, sir.
They fucking up one part of
they
the
got
show. And they don't
somebody.
Have shit to
because
do
they think
with how
part
good
of the show
comedian
too.
Is or none of that. It's just, that's just their thing.
Mm-hmm.
I had one show at this school. They heckled me all night with Desi Banks. Fucking, yes, sir. I was like, that nigga not coming. But apparently, his joke went viral. And this just what they say around campus all the time. Like, everybody say that, the whole fucking school.
Yes,
so
sir.
Even I'm up here rocking. I'm just like, yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. Man, why y'all just ain't called this nigga then? But I called him. I was like, bro, you got to come up here because they love your stinking ass.
For real.
Yes, yeah. sir.
Damn.
Hell yeah. I was like, y'all did not have
I like
to
seeing him
me
do
if
his
that's
thing.
What y'all
right. He be going crazy.
I like him. Desi. I'm going to tell you who I like on social media doing them skits now.
Who that?
I like Desi Banks. I like Drewski. What's his name? Drewski 2K.
Yeah,
funny.
Drewski.
I like
Drewski
2K. I like your boy Moneybag Mafia.
Mo Def, yeah. He go stupid.
That nigga stupid.
He stupid.
I like Super Cam Chard. Supercharged
Cam. Get fucked by none of that!
Yeah.
That
right.
nigga hilarious.
You know who funny to me, bro?
It's one more.
You know who's funny to me, bro? Lala.
Lala.
Lala is hilarious.
Which one is Lala?
Skinny
Lala Scissorhands.
No, skinny Lala.
Yeah, that's her.
Yeah, but what she
Lala Milan now.
Yes.
It used to be Lala Scissorhands.
Listen, man. You want to laugh, man? Hey, man, that girl crazy as fuck,
Lala
man.
Lala Milan.
Yeah.
I'm gonna check it. I like her. Pretty V too.
Pretty V.
Oh, Pretty V, I was trying.
Pretty V, my little young girl. I like her. She be doing her shit. She funny as hell.
Nah, she funny as
she's
hell.
She's talented, actually.
She do her thing.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of them that coming up that doing their thing. I just want them to stay down and stay consistent and knowing that.
You know, in a few years, you finna be OG. You damn near OG to these niggas now.
Yeah, oh, hold you know, on. I let them do that thing.
You OG. Let me shout out some more of them niggas. The nigga always be making me laugh. Tony Baker with the voiceovers.
Yeah.
Tony Baker.
But he OG to
but
the
But he OG media. Though.
He yeah. damn near up there with me when it comes to social media shit.
Kerwin Claiborne, that nigga hilarious.
Real?
What's the dude that be doing the Christian?
He still got that shit.
Kevin, is it on stage, Kevin?
Kev on stage.
Kev on stage.
I be having to go check him out because I don't even be watching people like that.
He do like, it's not, he don't even come off like a Christian comedy, but.
Right.
He got that dead clean shit.
Yeah.
But then he's like, still a real nigga with.
Yeah.
But I do want them to know that they can definitely transition that and take it to on stage.
Of course, Country Wayne too.
Oh, Country Wayne going crazy, but he done transitioned into that motherfucker on stage.
That's how he's supposed to.
He going crazy.
Yeah.
You see what
but he took his time just like you did. That's why people respect you. And not that y'all need the comedians' respect, the OG comedians' respect, but. When we see people like you, like I told people all the time, when I saw you, I was like, oh, he gonna be all right. Just the fact of you being on stage.
Yeah.
Right.
You gotta get in that war.
You gotta get in that war. You gotta
fight. You gonna fight.
You know what I'm saying? And honestly, you don't even have to do it. Because at this point, y'all can make a living without doing stand-up. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, the fact that you're still doing it, and you ain't gotta do it,
but
that
says a lot. But you know, it feel good, you know what I'm saying, just to get in tune with the people, you know what I'm saying? Like, they gonna really let you know what hit.
And let me tell you why it worked in your favor, too. Because now, that's the only thing working now.
Right.
It's stand-up comedy. And all the niggas that were just making
And you can forever go on the road with that forever.
That's what I'm saying. That's the only, I'm talking about in all entertainment.
Right.
Not even rappers ain't making no money. Only people making money is niggas that know how to do stand-up.
Right. Right.
So it work in your favor. Now, unlike the other niggas that's on social media
that
just stuck to just doing skits and this, that, whatever. They ain't got nowhere else to make
money.
But
I don't it's a few of them that fake like they gonna actually start doing comedy. Like every year, every year they come out, but all right, man, I'm out here.
Because they want to do it.
But it's just
they scared.
Hey, but this is a real game,
though.
The
more
you
do one, you're going to get better.
But you got to understand, this stand-up shit is a real game.
But on social media, you don't have to deal with the failures.
Because you there by yourself.
Yeah, so when they get up on stage,
but stand-up is a real fight.
Yeah, you ain't editing. Ain't no editing on stage.
Oh, no, sir. You better go for what you know.
Yeah, it is what it is. It is what it is.
But you know what? I always give respect to the OGs. It's crazy because I did a radio and they were like my top five comedians.
I shot
a low side. But just the OGs that paved the way, and since I'm gonna be a stand-up comedian, this ain't nothing that motherfuckers is just rocking with me with. And this is just a title that I got. And then it's like, look, I'm a stand-up comedian. Y'all gotta take it for what I give it to y'all. That ain't what that was. So I had to go figure out, what is a stand-up comic? What does a stand-up comic do? Who is he to say he is a stand-up comic? We don't really choose it. This shit choose us. You see what I'm saying? So it was like, all right. Once I know that, it was like, all right. Now I got to find my voice on stage. What is my purpose? How do I, where's my strengths? Where's my weaknesses?
See, check this out. And this one of them, you know, comedian stands up.
Right.
Anybody can be a stand-up comic.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, a stand-up comic, you know, can say funny things.
Right.
But a comedian can say things funny.
Right.
So even to be a comedian, you still have to go on stage to, shrink down to the stand-up comic. Like, the stand-up comic is a small part of the comedian. Like, you're a comedian, because you can be funny on a song, you can be funny in a play, on a you know what I mean?
It's right.
That's a comedian.
Oh,
stand-up comedy.
But that's what I'm saying. How do I perfect the stand-up?
Stand on stage.
You see what I'm saying?
Just stay on stage. That's the key to all this.
And that's
shit.
The craziest part.
I don't
about
tell nobody
comedy.
How to do comedy. I just tell them, just stay on stage.
It ain't no right way to do it.
I always tell motherfuckers to do
it. Ain't no blueprint to this shit. Just
do it.
And
that's the shit that used to make shit like Def Jam dope. Because everybody came to the stage different. They found a way to make their shit different.
Right. Different voice.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, if you watch Def Comedy Jam, 90% of the motherfuckers who do comedy gonna grab the motherfucking microphone, move the mic stand out the way. Then you'll see an old nigga come on stage and that nigga just turn to the side and tell all these jokes and still get, you know what I'm saying? It's like, they had little nuances that made the shit funny. Now it's like, everybody watch who's the funny comedian.
What works? Let me see.
Safe. What works? Right. He got a joke about this, I got a joke about that.
Right.
I know the shit gonna work because I got a whole duplicate of what works.
Right.
And that's what makes comedy suck.
And they ain't got no no choice because
that's
you get
all
thrown
know.
At. Nah, if a motherfucker, if I was 20 years old and I'm viral and a nigga offered me $5,000 to come up to a city, I'm gonna do it too.
But you know what? I ain't take money.
But they know they gotta do 45 minutes, so now in that 45 minutes, they gotta hurry up with some material.
Right.
So they going whatever they see work.
But you see, but see, that's what I said, I gotta go tap in to go figure that out. So I didn't go take money when they started calling. Hey, they started calling. 4,500, five racks. Can he do 15, 20 minutes? I'm like, wow, I don't even know what the fuck. I don't even want to go out there and even have that name.
Me neither.
You feel what I'm saying? And burn myself out.
I would never want to set myself up.
And burn myself out. I said, nah. Since they call them, just stay hot on Instagram. But I'm going to go do the workout rooms and just come up with some materials and get fat. Yeah. So that's what I did. I did that
you
for
did
a year.
You did the shit right.
You did it right.
Because if you would have did it the other way, oh you wouldn't. It won't, that shit, you could do that shit for 2 years. You get to make
two
one.
2 years? I don't even think it would have lasted that long.
You get to make one run, and then the whole world get to know, like, that nigga bullshitting on that stage.
Right.
They give you one more chance. But after that, it's over.
Right.
Nah, I want to make sure. When your work. Audience get mature, and they pay to see you laugh, like, the older audience, they really come for comedy. Young right. people, they don't know what comedy. Y'all actually teaching them what comedy is.
Right. right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, we came up on Def Comedy Jam. These young motherfuckers coming up on y'all wilding out.
Right.
So that's as they what their mindset of what comedy is.
Right.
So they don't really know. But when you get older, you live in life. So your comedy is life. That's right. why colleges is hard to do, because they ain't lived life yet.
Right. They still children.
Know. Yeah, they still children. They think they ain't. But when you get older and go through life, you really want comedy now.
Right.
So. It's a Talk different thing. So all that bullshit you was bullshitting when you was younger on these young kids, that ain't gonna work when you go do these comedy clubs with grown folks. Like when you do comedy clubs, do it be older motherfuckers. That's what they old
I
ladies.
Get them the grown. Cause yeah. ain't nothing but the grown.
Yeah. That's who spend money. That's where the consistent money is in adults.
Right.
Young people are finicky and fickle.
Right.
They fickle. Like shit. They like shit now, fickle. And then later on they
but
move
see,
on.
When you do
those colleges and
shit.
Cause it's about being cool when you're young.
Right.
And
right.
being on the same shit ain't cool when you're young. When you older, you want what you want. You don't want nothing else.
Right.
And they stick to it. If they fuck with you, they fuck with you.
Hey, what's up? What's going on? Is there something preventing you from finding your true happiness in life? Would you like to speak to a professional who may be able to help you? BetterHelp will assess your needs and match you with your own licensed professional therapist. You can start communicating in under 48 hours. It's not a crisis line. It's not self-help. It is professional counseling done securely online. There's a broad range of expertise available, which may not be locally available in many areas. The service is available for clients worldwide. You can speak to a professional online, so you don't have to be uncomfortable or be in an awkward situation speaking to somebody who may be able to address the issues you may or may not have. So seek help. Go to betterhelp.com. It's online. BetterHelp is committed to facilitating great therapeutic matches, so they make it easy and free to change counselors if needed. It's more affordable than traditional offline counseling, and financial aid is available. Visit betterhelp.com/85South. That's Better, H-E-L-P, and join over 1 million people taking charge of their mental health with the help of an experienced professional. Special offer for 85 South Show listeners. Get 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/85South. Here are some testimonials. I really appreciate Jennifer's empathy and kindness. I feel heard and supported. She has offered some really helpful practices. Hey, make sure you visit betterhelp.com/85South.
Right.
That's why I focus on them. I don't give a fuck what a young nigga think, because they ain't gonna be thinking it next week.
Right.
So it don't matter.
Right.
Stay woke.
So you when did. You do these colleges your, and shit.
But you ain't even had to lift that leg up, but it was already there. That nigga was like,
Yeah. So doing the colleges and shit, those just fans that's gonna come see you in 5, 6, 7, 8 years from now.
Mm-hmm.
It's just investing.
You just laying the foundation for them young niggas. Like,
right.
So like they can actually see you. A comedy
right.
show.
Cause I was the young nigga that was only doing, at one time I was the only nigga doing like comedy shows like that. Like hip hop, like for a young nigga hip hop. You know what I'm saying? So all them niggas not grown. So they grew with me, so that's why my shit's so, so I built that foundation.
Right, cause I remember.
You know what I'm saying? It's just like y'all doing right now. Like this generation, when you get my age, like y'all already laying the foundation now.
Right.
So when you get to this level, you gonna have a crowd. You never gonna fall off.
Right.
Like you pretty much planting your seeds right now for later on, because they gonna grow with you.
Right.
And cause they gonna, and when they get older, they gonna be like, hey, let's go see DC. That's because he's going to tell his old lady, because his old lady going to see it as nostalgia. You nostalgia. I'm nostalgia to most, a lot of people.
Right, right, right.
And that's what you want to be. It's, you want to be that song when it come on, you be like this. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, my nigga Duval in town. We got to go. We got to go.
We got to go.
Shoot it!
For real.
Karlous in this motherfucker. Hello.
You know why we like Nick Cannon so much? You know why people like Nick Cannon so much? Because they grew up on this nigga. From
everybody
Nickelodeon.
Did.
Right. It's kind of hard. It's kind of hard to not like somebody that you grew up with. Because right. it's like your family member. It's right. like a radio personality. You in the car with them every morning. That's why people like Ricky Smiley are gonna be there forever, or Tom Jordan can quit when he wanna quit.
Right.
Because you a part of the family.
Right. You nigga know you.
Yeah. Like they don't see us, they see us like friends. Like we a family member. You they cousin, you they cousin. You know what I'm saying? That's how they see it.
Right.
You know, that's and it works with you.
That's the cold part about this.
We ain't like the rappers, like they.
Right. The rappers got to try to make it hit every time.
Shit, it's hard.
But well, the rappers be thinking everybody gave up on them too soon.
Right.
Rappers
right.
got a career like football players.
You know what rappers saying? Start like, fucking up at? When they start doing the shit they want to do. Don't nobody want to hear the shit that they like. Nigga, do the shit that you know we like.
I got this new song. No!
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 I got this new artist.
I got this new
we
artist.
We don't want to hear him.
Let
we
the man rap.
We barely started fucking with you and you about to tell us about some more niggas. No! Man. Make another one like we like, bruh.
Let him rap.
Oh my God, speaking of, man, this fucking, I keep seeing this picture of Andre 3000 with this flute, man. This nigga got me fucked up.
I like it, he look happy.
But I say he happy as a motherfucker, but he think I won't buy the flute album. That's where he got me fucked up at. Where is it?
Where the fuck is this nigga playing this flute?
It must be a flute album. Cover.
It is.
It must be.
It's a flute.
Where is he walking from? Where is he walking from with this damn flute?
Hey, it looked like he was at Whole Foods.
I'm not the type that's gonna get in nobody's business, but yeah. I know my nigga got some flute shit laid down somewhere.
He looked like he wanted to swing on that nigga
some
real
bars
top.
On top of it.
You seen it? He was like, "Hey man, is it you?" He was like, "Yeah."
Fuck like, what y'all talking about. Andre looked like goals to me. That man. Nigga looked like he
that
was
nigga
happy.
Looked happy as a
nah. He definitely looked like in his zone.
He looked like he forgot he used to rap. He was like, "I did what?" Oh yeah, I remember back in the day I used to do that little thing. That's goals when you get to the point you don't even care about this shit.
Hey, man,
you know what I'm saying? I'm almost there.
This is the crazy part though, man, when it comes to this nigga.
Shit.
We not even asking for no new shit. We
he
just
hate,
wanna hear the shit.
He hate rapping.
I don't you know what? I don't even want to take him out of his happiness. Cause it looked like he's so happy, like, you know what, I don't even want you to sing nothing no more.
Nigga, share that.
He probably got some fire ass shit written
yeah,
up.
I wanna see him do
these
that.
Motherfucker
I wanna
that
see him
like,
I wanted that happiness. Show me that happiness.
I didn't
need to. You don't want nobody
rap.
To see him that happy.
I know that nigga got three songs that'll change my life somewhere. I just want to hear them motherfuckers. He ain't got to leave them out. He can just drop them
so
just
got
for
flute.
You. No, I'm just saying for us.
Okay.
It's more
got
people
flute.
Like me.
Boop, boop, boop.
I listen to that. It don't have to have no.
So for your own selfish personal reasons.
So I can be as happy as this nigga appears to be?
Yeah.
Come on now. I don't ask for much.
That nigga got caught with the flute. And then I seen people say, man, he always having the flute. The hell y'all be seeing this nigga with this flute?
I thought it was a stick.
I know what I'm gonna have to do. Since that shit I said ain't gonna work. I'm just gonna have to find the nigga playing in the flute playing move one day and just pull up. At one of these concerts or something. Is it doing?
Damn, he don't be at concerts. He be like at the gas station.
Shit.
For real? He want to be regular that bad?
Bro, it ain't want to be regular. He is regular. We all regular. He just.
Nah, I mean, he regular, but you know how like you gifted with a talent that's just.
Dog, when you get to a certain point, I know, like, it takes for you to get to that point to be like, oh, damn, now I get Andre. Now I get Ricky Williams. Now I get this nigga. Now I get Jim Carrey. But you got to get to that point. Mentally.
Right.
I get it. You know what I'm saying? I get why they like that. You know what I'm saying? But once you get to that point, you can be like, all right, I don't want to go that far.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You got to be able to adjust to stay in this world,
right.
But understand that piece too.
Right, right, right.
Now, I understand everything Jim going through. I just don't want to go that far. You
know
what I'm
saying?
What
he doing like, now? No,
he's
man.
Cool. He's doing everything he's supposed to do. He's at peace and everything. But at the same time, I still like to be able to talk to the common folk, you know
right,
what I'm saying?
Right,
like,
right.
He probably don't, he see them, but he see them for what they really are.
Right, you know he started like, to tell them.
I know exactly, no, he don't talk shit on them, but I know exactly how you see every human being, like how I see all y'all right now.
Right.
But I won't say it because I want to enjoy y'all how y'all are.
God damn, motherfucker, how you looking at me?
That's what.
That nigga said, I ain't gonna tell you how I see you, powerful, but I'm just enjoying the moment.
It's a powerful thing, man.
You's a fuck nigga. That's what I just thought.
Nah, it ain't God even no fuck nigga, man. It ain't even that.
Fuck us.
It's a
we gotta get a new carpet, man.
You just observe motherfuckers.
Nah, just a understanding just life in general and living and moving right. And understanding the earth and do some shrooms and that'll tell you everything.
That's the difference.
That's what you need.
You've been holding out on
do, the shrooms. Do some shrooms.
Nigga Duval think I'm a fuck nigga, man. That's
no,
fuck.
I don't, man. It ain't
I was
got nothing
glad.
To do with it.
I was
even say, this don't even feel like no fuck nigga energy in here.
Okay, good then.
It ain't.
I
you just scared me.
No fuck nigga
it
energy
ain't.
In here.
It ain't. It damn sure ain't. We checked it. This room has been pressurized. It is definitely. We even walked through here with the sage. We do not do fuck yeah, nigga yeah. energy in here.
Nah, Jim Carrey, that my nigga, man.
It ain't even enough room for no fuck nigga energy once you think about it.
Yeah, Jim Carrey get it. Like, dog, it's like one of the things when you get to, it's like money. Like,
right.
you don't realize you don't need money till you get it. Right. But you gotta get it.
You gotta get it.
You gotta see, like, yeah, this is some bullshit. It's like getting pussy. After you get the pussy, like, yeah. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it was cool, but I mean, I didn't need it.
What'd you say?
Like, it was cool, but I didn't need it. You know what I'm saying? So that's how everything is.
That's a low point to be at. Like,
it's like money don't make you happy, but
like when you,
you
want some pussy for so
it,
long
you know?
That it turned into you needing some pussy. Now, like when you want turn into a need, that is, right. As a man, that's a low place to be.
That's a low place to be?
Because it like, then you start like, please, I just need some pussy.
But everybody that watch this, this
I
crowd,
get vulnerable.
This crowd, y'all need to get money.
Yeah. Right.
This crowd need to get money.
Need to.
Don't do me at my age, not at y'all age. Like, I'm what you inspire to be, but in the meantime, get that bread.
That's the fucked up part about our audience, though. They young and rich.
But that's what y'all molding that generation.
They already
get some
got
money.
Money.
Buy some
not so much. I'm
shit.
Talking about the not just them niggas, but even the motherfuckers that might
I mean, like,
be.
Man, it's a few of these motherfuckers.
Because
like,
those be the ones that don't get money. The motherfuckers that got it, that was raised by money, they don't know how to get it.
But right. That's the thing.
Because they've been giving it to
that's
them.
That's the thing, Duval. Everybody got some money.
Right.
Everybody got some money to some extent.
You put up.
Now.
You got 10 bands and more, you up.
But that's what I'm saying. Your lot. Is not somebody else's lot.
Right.
You never know what they prepared right. For or what they already
and that's
got.
That's why I said get like
when,
money.
That's what I was saying. When we was on the road, man, we seen a bunch of motherfuckers big flexing like, and everybody knew how they had money. Like, man, that bitch won the lotto,
right.
The scratch off,
right.
$700,000.
Right.
And we like, everybody know this? Yeah, that bitch big flexing. She bought her mama a Jeep. They be like, damn, like, it just be type, crazy shit, nigga. We had a lady with a crab claw. She had money. You remember that lady?
Who?
The lady with.
Who?
She had long paper. I was like, where the fuck you get all this money at? Man, we was on stage talking about would you leave your girl if her hand was fucked up. We get to the fucking some
money?
Shit like that. We get to the meet and greet.
Bitch got a crab hand.
She rich.
She looked, she was
she
like,
has
I
money.
Started to say something when y'all was talking shit. This nigga done put it all over. You remember the lady with the
I don't know if she had money. Talking about the lady with the nub.
Yeah.
She had a claw, she had a nub.
She had the claw.
No, she did.
She had the finger.
No, it was no fingers.
It was some shit.
It was.
What's that nigga that's always hit me up that they say it was at y'all's show?
Right.
In the wheelchair.
Wheelchair man.
Hey, he be on your ass, too.
Man, he be on my
wheelchair
ass.
Wheelchair man, that's my partner, man.
You know, he one of the niggas I don't want to blow up because I want to be entertained by him just by his natural.
No, that's my
is
nigga.
Crazy. He done already blew up. This nigga got an OnlyFans page.
Yeah, but, oh, Lord, he did.
Shout.
We done mentioned him too many times. That shit done. Somebody told him, bro, you need to get this money. You got a fan base.
I'm scared.
What is he doing on his OnlyFans page?
Hey, don't tell him. Hey, don't, do
which
not
which one of you niggas subscribe
do
to
not click on that shit.
You know how much.
Do not click
nigga,
on that shit!
They done screenshotted his bio on his OnlyFans page. The nigga said, my leg don't work with this meat, dude.
Ooh!
I'm not even gonna read the rest because it's
scared.
Hey, how does he talk? Because you know his hands don't work neither. So how does he?
They
use a voice thing?
He smoked the blunt.
He rolled the blunt.
Yeah.
He can do everything. Listen, that's what he be having people fucked up at.
The butt
and
smart.
This
genius.
The chilling part. That nigga strong as a baby gorilla. That nigga has phenomenal upper body strength.
So if he grab you, it's over.
You ain't never looked at this nigga.
You in a chokehold.
That nigga had
I've
a video.
Seen this nigga
he wrapping it. He no. Wrapping around you like a monkey. I'm telling you,
this nigga be on Instagram, right? The nigga get up out the wheelchair and walk. All this part ripped. The nigga ripped.
Oh, he can walk?
Man, that nigga's walking everything. That nigga can run and all that
wheelchair
shit.
Wheelchair man, the truth, man.
I'm telling you, bro. That nigga, you got that nigga fucked up.
Subscribe that nigga only fan pay you want to.
You said the nigga hands don't work.
See, y'all done fucked up. Now this nigga finna be at me for the next week.
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
With y'all.
That nigga is not a person. That is a fucking robot. That nigga can roll blunts. So that nigga be cooking steak.
He gonna be at your next show like, and me.
So he wasn't a man in black. Watch this. Man in black alien.
It's the only nigga I ever seen fix his own wheelchair.
Drop the motor in that
the
bitch.
The nigga damn show had the wheelchair upside down, putting new wheels on that bitch, and he tagged me in the video when he finished.
Yup.
That nigga hands work.
Wheelchair man been the truth, I'm telling
bruh,
you.
Bruh, wheelchair man can do everything. That nigga got a college degree.
I gotta see it myself.
I'm telling you.
Is that what he showed on his OnlyFans? That's worth paying
for.
No,
that nigga trying to get hoes on his OnlyFans.
Oh, never mind.
Don't support that.
Nah.
I don't know who told that nigga get an OnlyFans page.
I'm scared.
He took shit way too far that motherfucking time.
I'm scared.
We do not condone that, but everybody, if you want to keep that nigga.
What if he on that hand song?
Tear her ass up.
Tear her ass up. He didn't even get out the seat.
He made Huck sit in the chair.
Come on.
What flavor is that?
Stop.
What flavor?
It's one right here. This fruit punch.
That's what I want, fruit punch.
Ain't no more Capri Suns.
Ain't no fruit punch. Cold? A cold one?
Hey, man, that's the next thing he gonna post. He gonna have a chick in there.
I'm telling you.
Stop, bro.
Say, give me my 10%. Give me my 10%, wheelchair, man. He gonna go crazy. This is it for you. Don't put me in that video, wheelchair, man.
Let him make it, man.
That my boy. You know, Shawty been on Vine since back then when I was fucking around.
Real?
Yeah, I fuck with wheelchair man.
He been talking big shit, bro.
Salute the wheelchair man and all your success.
You different.
All your success.
Hey, man, when you gonna bring the podcast back?
Man, we've been talking about it, man. I'm gonna bring the podcast back, have me and J-Ski on the podcast. Everybody
where J-Ski at?
Shit, I hope he ain't in jail. You know, this nigga stay in jail.
Damn. He good?
He out now.
All right, then.
Siri, which rapper got more money than everybody?
He was dead ass serious.
Dude, did that? And what Siri say?
Shit, it took him a minute to understand what the fuck he was saying.
Now they be putting that shit everywhere. Somebody made that nigga some cheesecake and they put that shit on the cheesecake. Who got the best cheesecake than everybody? Shout out to J-Ski.
Oh boy, J-Ski skills.
He the vice president of Rich Broke.
So what else we talking about? Cause I'm like my old nigga kicking in.
I feel you, man.
That's how it be.
That's what we about to talk about, how it's time to go ahead and goddamn.
That's how it be sometimes. Old nigga shit kick in.
Hell yeah. Don't let this be the last time you pull up at the trap, though, man.
This is a blessing, nigga, though. Y'all making some money doing nothing.
Really, we ain't doing shit?
Just chilling and vibing. Just, nigga, just being y'all. Nigga, this. You can't say it's more blessed than that.
Yeah,
right.
And that's the thing, man. We just
you know before
people
you,
that
you have to sit up here and do a whole lot, and now you can just be yourself and make money.
Yeah, we had to convince these people that we were good people, though. At this point, they trust us.
Right.
That's what I'm saying.
They know
that's
exactly
what
we're gonna do. Know what we gonna do. They know what we gonna say. They know that we don't play. Yeah. Every Friday,
come on,
we gonna drop something.
Come on,
we gonna load it up.
Yeah,
go on 85.
Uh-huh.
We gonna roll it up. Yeah, ain't gonna play with them. AK stay with him. Yeah, A don't play with him. Boy, you lay with them.
Play with them. You said stay with you with AK yet?
Nah, I got the pistol though.
No, you said the AK.
I know. But AK. I ain't want to say the pistol though.
You said the AK.
AK sound better.
AK sound better.
It's more ferocious. Hey man, did you think when you brought out the basic bitches, it was gonna do numbers like it's doing, still doing numbers?
I mean, it's just something you just put out there for the universe to work. I like to see, I get gratification to seeing motherfuckers that you wouldn't think say it.
Right.
You know, or seeing the world, like the world just use it as a common word.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Kind of probably how you be with fuck you mean.
Like, I knew the shit was real when Gabrielle Union said it. She was like, fuck you mean. I was like, oh!
Just saying.
I remember when your tag was kill yourself.
Yeah, it's like, but that come from doing stand-up. I just transferred it to social media because you know how we do callbacks?
Right.
And people know you for your callbacks?
Right.
I just do that on social media. It's like, boom. But I realized I can mold the ecosystem of the world with being me. So I just put it in words and put it in shit, and when I see people being me, it just makes me.
Really? But now you, but see, it's like the when you push it out and the tags that you choose, though, it'd be like, you'll pick some shit that's right there. Like, you get, like the most gangster nigga can never say, man, I got that found me, and niggas still not smile or something, you know what I mean? Like, that type of shit.
Because it represents moments in culture, you know what I'm saying? It's just like my music. When I put music out, I put out stuff that you can sing forever. Right. You know, or stuff that captures a moment.
Speaking of that, when you did that shit, what that was? What that comedy view when you did that?
Bitch Is My Girlfriend?
Yes.
Yeah.
That shit was kind of like that.
Classic. Yeah, that was
classic.
That was my first hit.
When you did that,
Smile, Bitch. My first hit was that Bitch You Is My Girlfriend.
When you did that, like, how did that, like, transition? Like, when you went crazy?
Man, actually, that was like my viral. Like, how you went viral?
Right.
That was my viral.
Right.
Like, because I was like how niggas, that's how I can relate to niggas on the Instagram, because comedians be hating on.
Right.
They used to do me like that because I blew up quick, because I hadn't been in comedy but about a year.
Right.
And then after a year or two, I did that. And I was out of here.
Right.
And so they was all hating and this, that, whatever. Because it wasn't so much hate, they just, to see a nigga come
nothing.
From and then pass right by him, you get bitter.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So just naturally, I guess. So the same thing with y'all. So when I seen how y'all do it, it just made me understand it more, you know what I'm saying? But it went and blew, and I just rode that motherfucking wave.
Right.
Because that shit was hot. That shit was like a hit song.
That shit was crazy. Shit. Cool kid, listen to that shit.
I didn't realize how big it was until I saw how they stood up on Comic View on TV. Like, that's why you on stage, you really don't really feel, like you feel it, but you don't really see how they really feeling it.
Right.
Yeah. And then when you see it on camera, you like, oh shit, they really was like screaming it.
Right.
And that was when I really said, oh shit, this shit is real. Cause like I used to get standing ovations for it every time I did it.
Okay, so take us through this process, right? That joke, classic, you created it, came up with it. When you thought about it during the process, how was you like, oh, this shit gonna be a killer on stage?
I thought about it from leaving the club and I bought a bitch a drink. And then when I was on the way home, I heard the beat and I was like, bitch, you is my. So I sat on the toilet. I was on Golden Walk. I was on Garden Walk.
See, don't nobody know this shit, though.
I was on Garden Walk off Riverdale.
Right.
The apartments there. I was in my bathroom, and I wrote that shit on a piece of paper. I was writing down the lyrics, and then I memorized, and I was getting on stage. Back then, it was real hard to rip. Like, you had to have a joke, or they were going to boot your ass off stage.
Right.
So I had to really know that shit, and I knew it was like, this shit got to hit. For me, when I hear that first initial, like, it's like, oh, I got him.
Right.
So when I heard that, and I was like, oh, this is a hit. And I kept doing it. It was one of them jokes I could do at any moment.
Right.
Like, certain jokes you could do at any moment.
Right.
And that shit gonna just hit. Like that's what a headline is, honestly. When you could do any crowd at any time, and that shit work at anything. This was one of them jokes, no matter where I did it, how I did it, it worked.
Right.
So I knew the shit was big, and I knew it was classic.
Right.
And then when I got on Comedy View, no, it was actually Cedric Entertainer.
Comedy All-Star.
But even with then, I didn't, you know how you hot, but you don't really feel it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But then Comedy View, because Comedy View stayed on.
Right.
Because it kept repeating over and over and over and over, so it was building.
The momentum still.
It was building y'all. Like,
we were watching the hell out of this shit.
We were watching the motherfucker, and I didn't realize it was getting bigger.
He was like, I was. Our big brother, you see Lil Duval?
Yeah, cause I was the only one that young people can identify with. Cause back then, motherfuckers wore suits.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. At that moment, like it went from Def Comedy Jam was was wearing hip hop shit.
Right.
And then when the Kings of Comedy came out, everybody started wearing suits.
Right.
So at that time, I was like wearing jerseys and dressing like a nigga.
Right, right.
Like a hood nigga. So naturally, you just identify just like hip hop. You identify what it was. And I had that whole culture at the time.
Right, right.
You know?
So well, I went crazy.
Man, did, I just rode the wave numbers. And all them niggas my age got my, well, they look a little older than me now, but but they shit, they with me now, like I told you later. I mean, like I told you earlier, they gonna grow with you and they gonna stay with you.
That shit was epic, boy.
And the young niggas gonna fuck with you just cause you
cool
than a motherfucker.
Right.
And you ain't trying to be them. That's where old niggas fuck up, still dressing like them young niggas.
They don't make that shit in old niggas' size.
No. I be telling Five Mics that all the time. Like, nigga, you dress too young for your face. Stop.
That's he gonna go crazy on your ass when he see this shit.
Like, man, you dress too young for your face. Like, that shit don't match. Like, come on.
Fight.
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 He gonna love this.
That my nigga, too. Hey, let me tell you something. I did not know that nigga was that cool. You not gonna know he that cool until you really get to know him. Cause he really one of them niggas that's not gonna speak, not gonna say nothing to you, and he's watching you the entire time.
Nah, Five is one of them. Well, and around me, he think he a comedian.
But he chilling though. When you get to know him, bro, nigga a nice guy. But I mean, he'll beat you up though.
He a great guy.
He a great guy.
But he's crazy too.
Yes. Yes, definitely. Five. Don't get it twisted. He's definitely, yeah.
He's definitely crazy.
But he's a great guy. That's why I tell the nigga, I said, bro.
He's a great guy.
For me to be your friend, don't nobody know you like this, bro. You crazy as fuck.
Man, he crazy as fuck.
For real. That's my nigga.
So, anything else you want to talk about? Because shit.
Alright. He talking about alright.
He liked that song. We all like it, but that's his shit, if that makes sense to you.
All right, so what's the question? How did I come up with it? It came up from a joke. Smile Bitch was a joke I used to always say on social media all the time, man. And I just, that's what all my songs, well, a lot of my songs come from my jokes. So I kind of feed it through the social media to get you familiar with it.
Mm-hmm.
Then I make a song, I used to make a song about it. And that was,
yeah,
I was dancing with it. It was just like one of my jokes. That's right. Like I said, like Basic Bitch. All these was tests for this shit. Basic Bitch, what that mouth do, shit, kill yourself. You know what I'm saying? I realized how much I got a hold on the culture. So I'm like, and then I also tested by putting other people on. You know what I'm saying? Like I was like, well, shit, A&R other people's shit. You know what I'm saying? Like shit, I bet you I can make this shit blow. Right. And it blow. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, well, shit, if I can do that, I can do that with my own shit. So, shit with that. Honestly, it was a lot to do with God too.
You know what I'm saying?
Because I mean, I put out a lot of other songs, but this song here was bigger than just a hit. It was just something for the people, for real. He just used me to get that message off. But for the most part, it was that my formula was that, and what I was going through with just I really live my best life. I always live my best life, even before the song.
Oh, that shit an anthem.
Yeah, it's an anthem. And watching one of my homeboys die from cancer. You know what I'm saying? That taught me a lot about living your best life, you know? So all that made a play for it.
Man, rest in peace, Kool-Aid. That was
Yeah,
cool
Kool-Aid was a genuine
RIP,
dude.
Man.
He's genuine, always
good guy. And he was a funny nigga, too. He funny comedian.
He used to always hit me to come up there to fuck with him in Detroit. That nigga used to wait till it was the fucking cold. Man, come fuck with me at Knicks.
Yeah. Like, people think living my best life is supposed to be about happy, but it's about times like this now, like when you ain't got no choice but to live your best life.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's why I learned through Kool-Aid. You learn, like, I tell everybody, live life like you know you finna die next year. Like, if you know you finna die next year, you'll do what really matters. You'll care about what really matters.
Right.
And that's how I live. I live, now I still get money too, but at the same time, I'm enjoying my motherfucking life, and I ain't gonna let no shit scare me.
Right.
We all gonna die. We all gonna die, so fuck it. Ball.
Ball.
Yeah. You know
ball
what I'm
to your mother, I'm telling you.
But it ain't gonna be the day, though.
It ain't gonna be the day. I'm gonna live a long time, because I'm short. Short niggas live a long time. But I mean, eventually, even that is gonna come to an end.
Short niggas do live to like 88. You like, yeah, damn.
Be 106 around this bitch.
I want to live long
Deacon,
just to see
Deacon
how
Duval.
I just want to see how this shit play out. That's why I want to live long, just to see how, like, God damn. Because shit changing now.
30 years? That shit going to be crazy.
Nigga, 20 years it done changed. Like, could you imagine telling niggas back in the day how the shit is now? Like,
right.
They'd be like, man, get your ass out of here.
I rolled past my middle school and I was just up there like, damn, look at this shit.
Like, you'd be like, I'm talking about 20 years ago, you'd be like, man, you know, niggas gonna be cool with snitching. That's what they gonna, you be like, get the fuck out of here. You like snitching, rappers or snitches now. You wouldn't be able, niggas would punch you in your face 20 years ago, say some shit, and that's gonna be the hottest rap or one of the hottest. That's how different shit, and that's just in a matter of 20 years.
Right. Shit, you know, crazy.
Shit changed. It evolved. So I just can imagine what is gonna be 20 years from now. Cause it's moving
shit,
fast.
But that's the crazy thing. 20 years ain't even that long time.
But see, the older you get, you can watch from the outside looking in. You ain't got to be a part of the bullshit. I could just watch. Like, that's how I feel now. I'm at the age now where I can watch from the comfort of my home. Niggas do stupid shit.
Right.
Like,
I done already put in my stupid shit.
Yeah, I done put in my stupid hours.
Yeah, I'm talking about overtime.
Yeah, I can watch y'all niggas.
I drug it in the dirt.
Fuck that shit. I like watching.
Just plain stupid. Every time you get caught, they just look at you and be like, you just plain.
I hate when people stop young niggas from fucking up. I'm like, no, you fucking up my entertainment. Let them fuck up.
Hell nah, them niggas in the way. Yeah, stop let that
them,
shit.
Let them, but they, that's how you learn your lesson through your fuck ups. We fucking up their growth. Let them
fuck
up.
We can't let
up.
Them just fuck up too hard.
Nah, let them fuck up. That's part of the ecosystem. We need
fuck
them.
Fuck all the way up.
Fuck up, because somebody gonna learn from his fuck up. You see what I'm saying?
But if we stop one fuck up, then you can learn from the fuck up.
Yeah, but a lot of people can learn from one ass whooping. Like, you see one of you, like, nah, I ain't finna try that. And then you like, nope, I ain't.
They don't learn from one death.
Niggas don't learn, but some niggas do.
But think about it, if one nigga die from a gun violence, get what? Another nigga gonna die from gun violence, and then another nigga gonna die from gun violence. So that
that's
shit
the
don't...
most extreme situation. Mm-hmm.
You talking about extreme.
But think about an ass whooping, though. Nigga ain't scared of an ass whooping.
Ass whooping build character.
Yeah.
Bullet can't bring nigga back.
A bullet, and if you don't die, you'll learn a lot from while you bullshit.
Shit,
a lot of people do. They ain't get shot right. Shit, you learn like a lot of humble niggas around this bitch.
They don't even want no smoke. He got me.
I know niggas, soon as they can tell a gun in the room, they can feel the lead.
Right.
Like, niggas ain't shit. Nigga, I know niggas, it's some niggas ain't been to jail long enough. You can't get a nigga that did 10 years to go cross the street jaywalking. Nigga do 2 years, they still come out. Nigga do 10 years, they ain't fucking off.
It might not even take the whole 10. It's right at five. Nigga be like, man,
I'm at the age. See, you at the age where a lot of your niggas locked up. I'm at the age where them niggas done came out and they just regular now.
Like, they done came out. They done came home from the real bitch. Yeah, 12, like 13.
Like, they done came home from 20 years.
Yeah. See, my nigga good, man. We ain't doing all that stupid ass shit.
No, I ain't talking about your personal niggas. No, I'm saying, but
we done learned from them niggas, though.
Shit.
But that's what I'm saying. You learn from the outskirts of when you
so
see
you learn from wrong.
But you learn from the outskirts. I ain't saying go grab a motherfucker, but if they are on reach, shit, I'm gonna stop that shit.
No, I'm gonna give a nigga one chance. Right. I'm gonna say, hey, man, and you know these niggas like to tell you.
But once you see a gun though, and all that, I'm going,
I'm talking about, I'm straight up to give you one chance. After that, all right, do you.
I ain't Superman. Fuck that shit.
My favorite line for young niggas is,
y'all niggas
see,
do not, everybody shoot.
That is what the old niggas always say. Keep living.
You'll see. Now, my line is, you'll see.
Who?
And I love to say I told you so. I live for that. So.
I mind my business, though.
Don't even come around me if I told you first, because I'm going to make sure you remember.
I love to hear a young nigga playing. That shit be so funny.
That shit be so funny.
Like, for real, yeah. And then I'm going to get 600, and then I'm going to put half of that up. And put the 300 up, and then I'm going to put half of that up.
They got it all figured out.
Yeah.
But I mean, that's cool that they got some type of plan.
Yeah, you better.
You better have something, because.
I want an old head that ain't gonna knock.
No, it ain't gonna work.
You see what I'm saying?
But you can't tell him that. You can't tell him that.
But see, I'm the OG that ain't gonna knock. I'm like, man, try that, y'all. You dig what I'm saying? You gotta go crazy, because get what? I remember when a nigga ain't had no type of faith in the nigga. Remember, and get who came out on top. Get your money. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm gonna motivate the nigga, cause the more motivation you give him, the less he ain't gonna fuck with you anyway. Yeah. So he out your way. The more he feel like you don't fuck with him or you a crab, nigga, you a victim. You all might right. fall victim.
This some game right here.
You dig what I'm saying? You gotta motivate a young nigga. That's what I mean by grabbing.
When niggas run up on you and they want to pitch the business idea, don't never say these. These are gonna kill your whole thing. Don't never say, all we gotta do is. Don't never say
all you gotta do.
You might have a legit pitch, but if a nigga hear you say,
all you gotta do.
All we gotta do. Why is it we already? You done included me too fast.
It's a scam.
That's the shit I was uncomfortable.
It's a scam already.
Whoa. You get to run the original idea by me first before I'm included. Maybe the second time you tell the story. All we gotta do. Nah.
He gonna be like, you right.
Right. Man, well, we appreciate you fucking with us down here at the trap tonight.
Most definitely, OG.
Oh, good.
Shit been litty. I gotta ride my motorcycle back. Yeah. Y'all bullshit.
I mean, we don't have to tell these motherfuckers to follow you on shit because they already do.
Yeah, it's all love, nigga, man. I'm coming back more often, man. I know I should have been here sooner, but.
Yeah, man, you bullshit, man.
I'm gonna come back and vibe with you. I'm gonna come with Chico here too.
Swole head, man. You
know, he so. Coming back. He'll be here soon, man. But yeah, this is
back like his braids.
Yeah, this is definitely been a great first trip to the trap, man.
Yeah, man. Shit, I gotta show you the video too.
Okay, bet.
I gotta show you.
Yeah. Oh, man.
So look, man, this has been the 85 South Show. It's your man Karlous Miller.
You did, DC Young Flizzle, huh?
Lil Duval.
And we out this bitch, but we in this bitch. Good night.
We
hit a lick.
But you ain't never told nobody that story lie, have you?
Which one?
How you came up with that song?
I don't think so.
For real.
Taking a shit.
Here you go.
Yeah, nah.
Here go the one of the cuts, brother.
You said taking a shit.
What that for right there?
You don't worry, be happy. Song I did.
That's a comedy shit.
That's a real song.